weren't born, just squeezed out of a bartender's rag.
Good.
All right, so this is session, like, 9, or something like that.
I'll look it up. I'll tell you.
East Texas University.
Everybody who's following us already knows what session number it is, because they've been waiting for this for a month.
All two people.
Oh, is that you people out there? Thank you. I don't know why.
I haven't even published the first one yet, so we'll get them all eventually. All
right, so when we last left our enterprising college students, I'll go with that one, they had successfully been involved in their first ritual.
Yep, session 7. Juan Lo was not involved in that ritual. He wants everybody, including God, to know that.
Especially God.
Did we make the light?
I had a little chat with them. I told them you're all good.
We made the light.
We made the light.
You made both.
Yeah.
I think he did both.
He demonstrated the light, and then we...
No, I think he did the light, and then he demoed the...
Oh, we took the spine from the creature.
Right, which consumed the spine.
And it consumed the spine, but we saw a picture, or a little piece of the spine, and then we saw what the whole thing looked like.
Right.
You
have been drawn to the partially rebuilt roost where you retrieved a leather case with the name Nina Castle imprinted on it. Inside you found a gold crucifix necklace, 4 inches tall, ending in a sharp point at the bottom. It looked like a gold chain was crudely attached to the top and not part of the original artifact.
And the cross itself is gold?
Yes.
Okay.
It was intricately etched with patterns within patterns that defied the eye.
Because is anybody thinking that this is a vampire snaking thing? I totally pictured Buffy having one of these.
What are y'all talking about? There's no such thing as vampires. They don't exist.
Out of game.
Researching Anita found little. She was a student back when the school was named Southeast Texas Institute. That would have been the late 40s, early 50s. Digging through old newspapers, Trout was able to find a brief article about her burned body being found on the new basketball court. The roost was new then. Not new now.
So I don't know why it wasn't South Houston Institute. I think that would have been a fantastic name.
And her death was ruled an accident, although there weren't any real details. How a burned body could end up in the middle of the basketball court.
By accident.
We'll leave up to the imagination of the listener.
I got burned a few times in the basketball court.
I asked if you guys had the cross or if you gave it to Glenn Mack.
Now,
I think you're right. I think we kept it because
she
told us to guard it.
So I'm guessing if we kept it, we either kept it with Johnny Moon or with Joe Dippy.
We said we were going to bring it to him.
I don't think we would let it to people after this.
I think we said we were going to bring it to him like the next day so he could look at it,
yeah.
But not while we're there or something like that.
Yeah,
I think he was taking pictures of it to research it for you.
Yeah. Oh, and we had midterm exams or something.
Oh, yeah.
Last time around, and we all passed, surprisingly.
That's right. Somehow we got enough study.
Hey, come on in.
Whoa!
All right, just in time to miss the recap.
I already
recapped on the way down.
What the heck is next door?
What?
It's like a werewolf?
Oh, they have some of the biggest dogs on the planet next door.
I thought you were talking about
the
bat.
I shit my pants. It was so deep. It was I swear, I was frozen for a minute.
It's the chupacabra.
He's
been sitting in his car for half an hour.
It was huge. I don't know what they have. It's a bear or something.
Did it scratch you, Chris? This is an important question. Did it get scratched?
You got the roof here.
Oh,
you got the roof here?
Yeah.
You want what?
You guys are in for a treat.
It is root beery.
You want to try it out?
Actually,
you can have a sip of mine.
I want a sip of that, actually.
You can have a sip of mine.
You want one.
What company?
No, he's not drinking.
You don't want any of that.
Give him a sip of mine, and then I'll take it back.
Well, I don't particularly like root beer, but I've got to try it.
I'll take a root beer.
Yeah, this is
this like 3-1. 3 parts Yingling, 1 part root beer, and it still tasted delicious.
Dang it.
I have Yingling and
a little sweet.
What's up, my guys? How you doing?
It's root beer.
Nice seeing you guys.
You got to sip it.
Hey,
so, Chris, by the way,
I don't like root beer.
The decision was, while physically you could have done the tough winter without a problem Saturday, you weren't holding off.
I wasn't old. Okay.
You weren't over 40. You weren't 40.
Really? Is that what it was?
The minimum age was Jeff. Our team was Jeff, who was 40. Yeah.
So that's why you and I couldn't do it.
You couldn't do it.
Yeah, too young.
Hey, Chris?
Yeah.
I don't want to be concerned, but I just 20 minutes ago have an email from you. It's actually to everybody on this thread. I'm in Africa, and I need your help. I need you to wire me money. Please respond to this email and wire money.
And your spelling was atrocious.
That wasn't for me. You know how you get those emails from those people,
mm-hmm.
and nothing's spelled right.
That's because I wrote it as a spare.
You know, if I were an English teacher getting underpaid in American schools,
you really have one?
I would move to Nigeria, and I would teach the spammers how to spell and do grammar, and I would make millions.
I wonder if they do it to bypass your
mistakes. Someone will pass on that out. You've been here so long.
What's going on? No, I'm still doing that.
To just see if...
Bob, can you pick a card, please?
I would be happy to pick a card. I'm going to go in the middle of the deck. Right. And the card that we've chosen tonight is the Queen of Clubs. Queen of Clubs.
Couple dog toes.
Now, remember that card? I haven't seen it. I'm going to put it back.
What's going on, Mikey? Wait, should it be the three of clubs?
We made it out of a jungle. This was the dorm.
You were listening to the audio from
Queen
the
of
now?
Clubs.
Don't you?
Oh, yeah, I did share it with him.
I thought I said you didn't pull. Oh, yeah.
Hi, Mom.
Chris.
Yeah,
I just.
Yeah, so
what are you doing for vacation?
We went camping this weekend up in Rhode Island. Did some day trips. I forgot what we did. We've been. Then Nate, my guy, and I went geocaching today, so we're all over geocaching.
That's nice.
Cheshire and all that.
You've got
you something, Bob.
It's awesome. Yeah, it's cool. Get your phone, GPS, and just walk around, and it's really good. All right, cool.
All right, so.
Welcome back.
Back to East Texas University.
What's the name of your guy again?
Yeah, it's Ford.
Ford Prefect.
And you're the journalism major, right?
Journalism guy. Okay. But I feel like he's got some mysteriousness about him that we haven't known.
Are we going to see him more often, Chris, or no? Or is this a special treatment?
No. Absolutely. Forget work.
How was work?
Forget work. Good, we're fully staffed. Now we just have the normal issues that you normally would.
Oh, people
suck. So you're at steady state.
Yeah.
Why are you replacing people?
Yeah, I'm done with that. I'm done with that. I'm not firing anybody. I don't care how bad they are. I swear to God.
Chris, Susan is stealing money from the
I was just going to say.
Listen, I need you to keep that yourself. There's telling and tattling. Right now, you're tattling.
If she steals 20s or 50s, tell me, okay? Fives and tens, whatever.
Here you go, Mikey.
Chris Jonathan just
you can almost see Chris now.
There he is.
In case you didn't believe it.
With a rifle.
Yes, I'm going to try to get down here more often. Yes, absolutely. So. Get work.
All right, so things have been kind of quiet since Roost. It's been a week or two. Glenn Mack and his compadre have been doing research. They haven't found anything terribly interesting about the cross. They do believe they found a name. It's De La Goza's cross.
Gozer?
What the?
Gozer?
It was actually created by the Aztecs, and then...
not the Mayans?
No.
What were you researching?
And then a Catholic priest added the cross piece and chain link to it to make it into a Christian artifact.
So what was it prior?
It was an Aztec artifact. It is imbued with some power they have not determined what it
was. Was it just an obelisk? Stick?
It was a rock.
Okay. Well, guys, isn't this a curious exercise? Because right now we could run that ritual to see what an original item looked like. Now, the cross has been in place for a couple of hundred years, but we all know thousands of years before that, the stick was there. So if we run that ritual that shows the original form of something, is it going to show the cross, or is it going to show the stick? Or is it going to show the component molten gold parts of what it was made of?
Where the gold was smelted.
What?
Luck.
Right.
Luck.
Yeah,
that's fascinating.
Not that I want to run an ritual, but...
But what happened last time you ran a ritual? It destroyed the artifact.
Yeah, but when they did the ritual last time, it destroyed the artifact, and I don't think we want to do that.
Well, that's true. I'm just doing intellectual exercise here.
What if we...
It's a good thing it's not 9 o'clock and we just get started.
Right.
What if we scrape the tiniest amount of gold...
Yeah.
And sell it.
Off of it. Then run the ritual on the tiny amount of gold.
I think
then it's going to show us the cross.
John and Moon, I like the way you think. And then here's another question. Let's say we take an ancient scroll, right, made of papyrus.
All right, so.
Wait, just let me finish this one. Just one more. And we run the ritual on an ancient scroll. Will we see a papyrus plant instead of what the rest of the scroll looked like? Because that's the original form.
Maybe it only works on living matter, too.
Oh, maybe.
Well, then in that case, we would see the reeds. The papyrus came from.
Maybe we would just see the component ink, but not the plant itself. Oh, so many questions. How does this thing work? We got to perform this ritual like at least 5 different tests, I can think of. Let's get cracking.
Josh bans rituals from this game.
You still have to take you have to spend your edge to take that ritual.
Yes, that's true. And that was Glenn Mack and the other guy, were they able to come up with... anything more with Nina Castle?
No, I told you what you guys found. What Trump
but
found.
What, they've been researching for 2 weeks. They couldn't find anything more than us. Nope. We spent like 20 minutes on this on the internet.
I thought
the
journalist.
No, Trump spent time in the photo archives.
No. Trump's not here. The journalism major found it in the archives.
Thanks, journalism major.
You're welcome.
So Ford magically showed up. Did a little research for you.
I was busy.
Did you look up,
sorry, guys.
Also,
I was busy in class. So Trout told you about this, and he asked you to research it.
Yep.
By the way, Ford, where have you been for, like, the past 5 weeks?
Do you all not go to class? Because
where?
I'm going to class.
We went to Mexico?
Oh, how did you do on your midterms?
I actually ate all my midterms, but I don't know where you all were.
Oh, I don't know. Does he have to roll for his midterms? Maybe you should have him roll.
He hasn't been here long enough. Maybe at the end of the night. We'll see how I feel. See how much more beer you're supplying me.
I'll get more.
That'd be fun, having him roll for adventures. Has he leveled up yet?
No.
We're going to have to bring Chris up to speed next later on.
No, I'm good. Keep going. All
right, so Johnny Moon's girlfriend, Missy Jordan,
who's our school,
approaches you guys one evening as you're hanging out watching TV.
Hello.
Well, Chris, we have a new one. This is Lola.
I tell everybody I'll be right back.
She was a princess.
And she needs your help.
Well, I was going to say, what's she wearing?
Help me.
This is Missy Jordan. It's your friend's girlfriend. Keep your thoughts to yourself.
Nigel.
It's not Jesse's girl. It's Johnny's girl.
I can stare all I want.
You can look.
You go for what?
But you better not touch.
Don't go that one. It's a huge dog. It was just killer. Like, nasty. Hope he's chained up.
I can ride that dog. Yeah. It's so big.
Is he? No?
No.
No.
Well, I could have been seriously dead.
No.
It's an English mastiff. He's a...
He just sounds like Barry White.
Yeah.
I just watched Harry Potter. All right.
Fang. Fang was a big deal.
Yes. But
yeah.
Still, what are you?
So. Anyway, she says her roommate Bonnie Elliot. You go to bed.
Facebook.
Oh, your bike. That's where you go. Gotcha.
Yeah.
She thinks her roommate Bonnie Elliot is in trouble.
What is she wearing?
I don't have a picture of Bonnie.
Nobody cares.
Nobody cares.
She's been spending a bunch of time at the Alpha Phi Sorority, and she doesn't seem right anymore.
Joking,
she's always exhausted, and she looks extremely worn out. It's like she never gets any sleep.
Wait, at the sorority house?
No, she's there during the day.
But has she started, like, cutting her hair real short?
No.
And, wearing boots?
No.
Well, why don't you reach out to your resident advisor? Maybe she's got an addiction to Adderall or Ritalin or something.
Because there's
like
just
that.
Something that... You know that feeling you got, because I was there in Mexico.
Mm.
When that spooky stuff started happening, I get that feeling when she comes around.
Oh.
And I know you guys have dealt with some spooky stuff already, and I was really hoping you could help check her out.
Alpha Pi?
Alpha Pi.
Wait, I've got a question. That's a house that's full of girls, is that right?
What is that sorority known for?
Listen, guys, I think we need to go undercover. Deep undercover.
Booze and Buddy undercover.
Booze and Buddy.
Revenge of the Nerds undercover or Booze and Buddies undercover?
Revenge of the Nerds, I think, would be a little better.
What's Booze and Buddy, Revenge of the Nerds, what's all that stuff?
Google it.
It's actually pronounced
Alpha. Mikey, you have Roll 20 running?
Yes, I do.
Okay, so there's the Alpha Phi house.
It's actually a P and then a Pi symbol.
It's actually Alpha
Phi.
Phi. Oh, it's a Phi.
Huh?
P-H-I.
Okay, it's Phi.
Phi.
I'm not comfortable with going into houses for women.
She reads your body.
It, okay, well, not close.
So, Missy goes on to further explain that she tried to follow Bonnie one night, and the Phi girls... interrupted her, wouldn't let her in, and actually threatened her to leave Bonnie alone.
So Revenge of the Nerds style.
So
she's kind of scared to go back there.
I checked the Greek life calendar.
Okay.
Are they having any
events?
Yeah, any events come up?
Maybe the journalism major will go there. Maybe it's important.
Is there anything in the school? Anything in the paper?
I don't remember. I heard they're having an open house tonight.
But I can make a call to my boss to see if there's anything going on.
Actually, Joe Diffie.
Joe Diffie has the schedule memorized.
He can't recall it in verbally. Trout recognizes that Alpha Phi is next to the frat house that Joe Diffie and he, his father, are legacies to.
Oh, the Deltas?
No, they're the Beta Sigmas.
Oh, okay.
I was nice to them.
Alpha Phi, Beta Sigma.
Nice and easy.
Are those the order of the N letters?
No.
Okay.
Alpha Beta.
Oh, I know about the Alpha Beta.
So Alpha Phi,
Beta
Sigma. It is actually Greek, like a Greek party weekend. It's the last weekend of Rush where they're trying to get all their people together.
So we just got to rush the sorority.
Finals, midterms, whatever.
They rush longer.
No, it's perfect. Right,
it's
after.
Not so much of a rush as a marathon.
This is why we need you more often.
You know, just getting started.
One thing of note is that the Alpha Phi house is relatively new. There was a fire 5 or 6 years back, and they rebuilt the house.
There's a lot of fires around here.
So
maybe we should do some research.
Yeah, maybe I...
Was it always Alpha Phi who lived there? Or was it...
Yes.
Okay.
We're going to go in anyway. I think I have to do some research about it and see maybe if there was a suspicious, how it happened, why it happened.
New floor plans.
Maybe I can go to the library and dig up some stuff. What do you all think?
I think I'm going to go do my physics homework. Just let me know when you need me.
But when you want to do anatomy by Braille, you let us know.
Hey-o.
Ba-da-ba.
Didn't know they offered Braille for anatomy. What?
We have football practice. you guys want to be back here in a couple hours?
All right. Yeah.
Wait, what? You want to help out?
want to come to the library with me?
Yeah, I'll give you a hand for class.
Excellent.
Not the Braille.
Okay, so.
Well, I thought we were
the local town library or
the library.
Well, there's a school library and there's a town.
Go to the school library.
All right.
All right.
First, you got time.
You got time. All right, so I go to the school library. I'm going to go ahead and...
Do you have investigate?
Oh, God, I hope I do.
Sure you do.
Maybe I don't.
I would expect as a journalism major, if you took the generic template, you would have investigate.
I have knowledge journalism.
But you should have the skill investigate.
Oh, skill.
I
don't know. How are we going
to
investigate?
Can he get that for his first level off streetwise?
Yes.
Does that make sense, Bob?
What's that?
Can you get that for his first level?
I'll let him level up for that if he wants.
Oh, yeah, if you want to level up and take it.
I'll let him have that as his level up.
I don't know. You got streetwise, though. You're really streetwise.
Wouldn't knowledge journalism take part in that?
That's the judge.
That's more for like what you... That's more
for what I'm doing.
Yeah.
Yes.
That you're, if you were to write about this, then yes, I would say journalism. Not that I actually have any say in this.
Well, that's horrible, man.
All right, you can't get your journalism.
Well, you'll be able to level up.
Oh, that's different. I don't have that machine.
Oh, yeah.
Joe Diffie, what are you up to, sir?
D4?
Yeah, do
we know? You're hanging out at Beta Sigma, checking the place out?
Can I be Danielson check at Beta Sigma?
Hey, ask around and see what the brothers say about Alpha Phi.
Yeah, level up after this.
Because I know...
I'll do some investigating around the frat house.
I know some frats have, like, sister sororities that they always have parties with, and I wonder if Alpha Phi has one.
Get a buy.
Absolutely.
Okay, so you find out that the house burned down 6 years ago. It was a result, there was a party going on, it got out of hand.
Fireball.
There was an Omega Moo who set the house on fire.
That was from ours. There's nothing that said that it might have been suspicious.
Hey, a lot of stuff burns down around here, and it never says it's suspicious.
Does it say who wrote the article?
Yeah, because you're right, guys.
Okay, let's figure it out.
Anything about the rebuilding?
Just that the alumni, you know, it's a national sorority, so between the alumni and the insurance and everything, they are the rebuild. House twice the size on the same lot.
When did it
fairly
happen?
Fairly quickly, 6 years ago.
So there's nobody left.
We could do a...
Any deaths?
Any super duper senior
journal? Yeah. Any deaths?
No deaths as part of the fire.
Okay. That was nice.
But there was a result of the fire.
Nobody died?
Insurance fire.
Yep.
It was the we want a bigger house fire.
Mm-hmm.
Our house.
So.
We'll see.
All right.
The local library, we can talk to them.
Hey, Joe Diffie, do you want to do an investigation or what do you got? What do you got for skills that you can use at the frat house?
I've got streetwise, persuasion. I don't really have investigate. I didn't take that, so.
There's always so many you can do.
That's the thing, right? So.
I'm gonna work really hard at practice. I'm gonna try to tackle the starting running back. 10.
You injure him. You take his place. Jeff's a practice. He injures somebody. Take his place. Coach doesn't like that, but you know what are you gonna do?
Hey, Ford. Maybe we go to town and check the library. There.
So what are the attributes you got, Mikey? What do you got for me? Come on, you gotta find something.
I'd agree.
Notice can always help.
You want to do notice? You can
check some police reports.
Maybe you can use
I've got notice. I've got streetwise. I've got persuasion.
I think the fireman. Would
maybe you can try to persuade somebody to let you see some of the fraternity records that going back then.
Yeah, we can try that one. I think that's good.
Remember that smell?
I mean, I could, you know. Or maybe they're, you know, just kind of walking around to see if I notice anything related to, maybe they've got, articles or something around about the old house or the old, you know, the
sure.
The or anything.
So, you want you to notice that, or?
I'll try and notice first, and then I'll see if I can persuade somebody to give me some information. If I don't see anything, just kind of snooping around.
All right.
So you want to notice, Roy? 7.
7. So you do notice that part of the house that was on the side of Alpha Phi looks like it has had some. I'm not gonna say recent, but it definitely had to be rebuilt or fixed in some manner. Probably some damage from the fire back then.
Okay.
Looking over there. It's like your dream world, dude. There's a big sun deck in the back. There's women scantily clad as Texas. Even if it is October, November, it's still plenty warm there. Scantily clad, tanning. Women are coming and going. From your chatting with the brothers, there's got to be at least 40 women living in that house.
That's good odds.
Yeah, that's even I got a chance there, yeah.
Even as a freshman, you might have a chance there.
Even as a freshman, even as a freshman pledge, I got a shot.
Let me
ask you a question. As I'm kind of wandering around and I'm kind of just checking out the house, do I know? So I have this psychologically sensitive thing now that kind of happened to me. How aware am I of that?
All right, so you took the... That's an edge, right? It's the new edge.
Well, it kind of just happened, remember?
Yes. And you get that for your next level up. Yeah, give me a second to find that, because I want to make sure I get the interpretation of that correctly.
+2 rolls made to sense or communicate with supernatural beings.
Yeah, so you're not getting supernatural beings here.
Okay.
You get some sweet hotties. Mm-hmm.
There's plenty of sweet hotties there.
Sweet hotties, no supernatural.
So, and just for fun, there's panties on the line drying.
Why are they drying?
Because they washed them.
Wow.
The wet t-shirt contest was over, and... How else do you think they're going
to
drown?
You look at that panty, you think, God, that doesn't even come with a dimple on her ass.
I just checked Facebook for a second.
Alabama Alpha Phi Sorority video is under fire for being too hot. Alpha Phi is a legitimate national sorority.
Essentially what I'm doing is as I'm walking around, I'm pretending like I'm texting, but I'm actually taking pictures of all the hot girls.
Okay.
I'm going to head down to the local library, see if there's anything deeper in the fire department, see if there's anything deeper that... We can talk about. Would that be investigate or persuasion?
It'd be more investigate still. Are you going with the
Munglo?
Munglo's driving.
doesn't somebody want to go down to the other bookstore and maybe see if our friend, if she might have any information related to the fire, if she thinks there's anything weird about it?
The bookstore? Well, let's work with Chris's stuff first.
Explosion. I had a 4 and explosion, so it's 2.
Ooh,
so 6.
Nice.
So you rolled a 4 and a 2?
Yeah, 4 and a 2.
Yeah, you find a lot of the same stuff. I mean, obviously you find the university version at the university.
Right.
You find the local paper version at the town library.
Match it up.
Match it up. Description of the event's pretty much the same. It's almost the same guy who wrote it. You find a few more references to building permits, approvals, and that kind of stuff. If you dig down into the further end. Nothing terribly exciting.
No quotes from any...
Can you just go into the microfiche section?
The investigation was pretty cut and dry. Four or five people saw somebody being stupid, lighting the place up. So...
What's in that book they talked about in Ghostbusters? Tobin's Spirit Guide.
Tobin's Spirit.
There's another one.
This is one of my friends who's at Alabama, but she's at Phi Mu. That's the Phi Mu part.
That's the kind of party like that.
This is one of my former students who's friends with me at Facebook. She's part of Phi Mu, and...
You gotta show. Hold up this. Hold up my little camera here, so Mike can see it, Jeff.
Phi Mu.
Just
said
it's a Phi
Mu.
Wow. There's a lot there.
Yeah.
Holy cow! There's a lot there. Now that that's no longer in the picture, man, that handsome dude sitting there picking his eyeball right now is—it's a weird face to have to see.
It's an ugly mug, but. Absorb it. Absorb it all.
So the least they do is this.
You were talking about Mary Lou's used books in Emporium, Mikey.
That is correct. That's the one I meant to say. Mary Lou's used books in Emporium. I'm not so much worried if Mary Lou's got a book on the fire, more as if she might think there was something weird about the fire.
I see.
There's also that man who knows all the history of the town, who we made good friends with during the scavenger. What was his name?
That's true too, there, Edison.
You guys don't know his name?
It's been like 2 months, real time. do you remember?
Yeah. I'm lucky I remember the people that I'm playing with their names.
You know, you think I don't know these things?
No.
Really?
Give me one more second to look. He's just stalling.
Where was it? I have the right document, if it helps.
Good talk, Monroe, yeah?
So, by the way, you're at the Cecil Greystone Memorial Library.
Yeah.
How is it with the whiskey of the room here?
Guy owns, where is it? How's it not on here? Guy owned the feed store.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's been so long, I didn't know what you guys had.
We don't drink anything anymore.
Yeah, I know. Since you stopped coming here.
There was 1 week, there was like 3 beers out of the... I had that before anybody else came.
Well, it helped with Josh's training for the tough mutter. He limited himself.
So, all right.
And I'm not drinking alcohol anymore for a while long.
Me either. No. Or any less.
Hidalgo. It was Hidalgo Hardware and Tractor Supply.
You
and it was Tony Hidalgo.
Yes.
He was the owner.
That's right.
36 years long.
So.
Perhaps we should go see Tony Hidalgo. I think he owned the tractor store.
Hey guys, Edison said you should go visit Tony.
I think we should. Let's make our way.
We'll go visit Mr. Hidalgo.
Ooh, I might have his picture stuff.
I'm okay with that.
I'm imagining Tony Danza. See, what
happened
to Angelo?
Viggo Mortensen from Hidalgo.
Oh, Hidalgo, great.
Was that the name of the horse?
Country Western, technical hat.
Which Tony Danza does not.
Hey.
Hey, welcome to Texas. Oh, hey.
Okay, I don't have
to. You guys want to play some baseball?
That was Andrew Dice Clay. Okay.
Oh,
Forget about it, huh?
So you find Tony Hidalgo is closing up shop as you get there later in the day.
What else can I do when you stand behind the bank?
The feed store is closing up. You know, obviously they don't need to stay open until 6 o'clock. Mm-hmm. So, what can I do for you boys?
I'm not there. I'm still at football.
Hey, you can be there now.
I'm down there now.
Next,
Mr. Hidalgo.
Yes.
Hi, my name is Edison.
Yeah, I never forget a face.
Wow, that's very impressive, sir. We recall when we met you earlier in the semester. You seem to have an encyclopedic knowledge of the history of the town, and we thought we might put that knowledge to the test if you wouldn't mind a couple of questions, sir.
Well, I was heading over to get a beer at the...
Pizza place? We'll get you some pizza?
Well, no,
I was going to the brewery.
So you were going to buy us beer?
Dude, I was going to the Brazen Hussy Brewery.
We're all 17 and 18.
Yeah,
we're remember 18. The, you're all 18.
Age 18 and,
the beer and wine drinking age is 18 within the...
Is it?
Okay,
let's go. I'm afraid I skipped a couple of grades, and I'm not sure if I'm old enough to... Yeah, he went to jail.
They have cards, 17-year-olds. They have soda.
That's not your father.
So, all right, so walk with me. Maybe when we get there, you can buy me a beer, and we'll talk some.
Oh, is that how it's going to go?
All right, sure.
Is Flounder with us?
Trout?
Sorry, Trout.
He's the only one with money.
I know.
Yeah, we'll all share a beer and buy one for him.
I have the job as the...
Lone Star. Lone Star's the chief...
The beer there is blonde, brunette, and redhead.
Oh, yeah. It's a microbrew. Ooh.
We need balls.
So maybe we're just going to buy him a beer.
BYO. All
right. Yeah. All right.
We'll
so
follow you, my friend.
You follow you. You
can walk and talk.
You head on down there. He keeps a small talk, you know. Pointing out interesting historical parts about the town, boring you guys to tears.
Edison is absolutely fascinated. Edison, his eyes are like the size of saucers.
I would love that. If somebody did that around Shelton.
Oh, I know.
I love that.
See that library there?
Yeah.
You see that column?
Yes, sir.
Back in like 1918, there was a minor earthquake here, which is unheard of. And it was actually a little bit cracked. And they were afraid the building was going to fall, and they had built it up. Took years to fix, because nobody knew what to do about it.
My God, that's
so
fascinating.
I don't know. I wasn't there. I just fixed it.
That's incredible.
Did you want to try root beer?
Ford, if you could look that up, maybe, when we get back.
Remember, I have my internet, and I'm connected. So we sit down.
Wanlo was initially fascinated by the story, but ends up being very disappointed.
Oh,
as an architecture major.
Oh, yeah.
Architecture. And then here's the one, the sheriff's office here, and the police office over there. And do you guys know why they have two of those?
Yes, we do.
I remember, but we didn't want one. That's right. One is campus security, you might recall, and the other represents the police state for the town.
That's right, young man.
One's county, one's town. Yeah, that's
the other one already came out tonight.
So which one's for the college?
Give us that.
I feel like sheriff doesn't
have root beer, and I don't have good memories.
Too many root beer floats with the wrong folks?
No.
That can't even taste the alcohol.
I love.
No, it doesn't taste like root beer.
That was my favorite soda.
That was
just strong alcohol.
Yeah, it's root beer beer.
That's why Josh is trying to give it to me again.
Very first.
Just pour it right in the back.
Yes.
You don't even taste it then.
Don't even let it touch it.
Like the sake.
Yeah, that's it.
So here's the library. This is the biggest library in the whole county.
Whoa.
And it has 17,852 different volumes.
Hey, do you know anything, speaking of buildings, do you know anything about the Alphi Phi Sorority House?
I might after I have a redhead tonight.
How convenient.
Right. Sir, I don't mean to judge your... what you do with your wife and your own time, but is there any chance you might talk to us before?
I think you meant a beer.
What? Oh, you meant a beer?
Yeah.
Oh.
I think so.
Oh.
Yeah, I wouldn't be talking to you about my redheaded wife.
Oh, all right. Sorry. Just thought, never mind.
I remember you are special one, son.
You are special.
That's what they said in grade school. They put me in the special class.
He hasn't changed a bit.
No, huh?
Did you make your helmet?
Does he have a special bus here? All right, it's kind of short.
Hey,
I love that bus. That's a great bus.
He just stopped wearing his helmet. All
right. Statistically, the short bus is a lot safer than the long bus. I just want you to know.
So you find yourself at the Brazen Husky Brewery.
Also,
you
have a 10% chance of survival if you stay in the back. It improves your chances significantly. Also true of airplanes.
You know, we're going to have to sit down and have a drink about this one day. But right now, I need to go wet my whistle. Because after this tour, because you guys ended up made it to the brewery during your tour. If you remember, you bought your beer at the local store.
Mm.
You didn't
That's
go
true.
To the...
We never had a bunch of college kids.
You
bought the beer at the liquor store. You didn't go to the brewery. So, it's a... let me see if they have a description here. Okay, a second.
Give him a tall redhead.
Did you listen to session 6 on the
wall? Yeah. Maybe a short blonde at the same time.
Short blonde, tall redhead. Oreo cookie. I'm the villain.
What does that mean? I don't understand.
All right, so you guys arrive at the brewery. It's a big old, probably was a factory at one point of some kind. And gutted it out. They've got half a dozen tanks to do the brewing. There's a small bottling section. There's a bar for tasting. There's no food on the menu. You got to order pizza from the place next door.
I was going to say, it was legal, but that's Texas.
So,
they have a drive-thru. You could buy guns.
There's also a small air conditioning area. I'll take a burrito and a 22.
No, because the bullet taped to the bottle.
So you order your beer by caliber.
That's right. Take a 45, please.
I'm not sure I've ever been in a brewery before. This place is nice.
I can arrange for a tour if you'd like.
Oh, yeah, maybe. After we talk to you about our questions, that'd be great.
Sure. I can give you a little story. I mean, the place was originally a brewery, and they declared bankruptcy because they just couldn't make it work. What? Then they came in, they renamed it.
That was in 1922.
They renamed it to break down. This was only about 6 years ago. About 3 years ago, actually, that some new townspeople came in. They renamed the Brazen Hussy as a gimmick, named them blondes, brunettes, and redheads. It's been doing okay since.
That's very misogynistic. Don't the local populace take offense to the name?
Do you see the picture on this bottle, son?
What?
Joe Diffie can't take his hands off the bottle.
She's not.
Joe Diffie, stop licking the bottle.
I have to excuse myself. My pants just felt very tight.
I can't get up right now.
I would, but she doesn't stop condensating.
My wife sure saw pretty good. So you guys drinking with me? I hate
jingle,
to drink
jingle,
alone.
Jingle, jingle, jingle.
I had a couple before I came.
Joe Diffie orders one.
Thank you.
Yeah, dip it.
How about you, cowboy? Injun Joe?
I don't have two nickels to rub together.
I buy a beer for Injun Joe if you want.
Thanks, buddy.
Wait, are you on the football team?
I am.
Oh, this one's on me.
I am now.
Oh, thank you.
This one's on me.
I'm starting running back this week.
Wow, why is that? Was it an injury or something?
Yeah, he's a little bit sore.
What happened?
I kind of gave him a chop block. And
his leg touched
the back of his head. Oh,
it was an accident. I didn't.
Oh, so they all say.
I turned around, he's right there.
So
ran into my clothesline.
So what did you want to talk about, boys?
We heard about the Alpha Phi Sorority House burned down a few years ago. We were just wondering if you knew anything about how it got burnt down, and also when they rebuilt it, they made it a lot bigger. I didn't know if you knew anything about the plans of how it was rebuilt.
Well, it was December 7th, 2009. It was the end of the semester, big blowout bash out there. As I understand it, they were just carrying on. What was her name? Well, she could party with the best of them. What was her name?
The journalist is taking notes, by the way.
Joy Hines. Man, that chick could come in here and drink most of the men at the table in here.
What?
Joy Hines. I don't know whatever happened to her, but apparently She got into the really hard alcohol, and she was trying to drink some guy on the table. You ever seen that clip in Raiders of the Lost Ark where Mary is sitting at a table?
We'd all know that.
We all go.
Save your breath.
Where Mary is sitting at the table.
What you talking about?
You got to educate your friend here.
What is Illinois Jones?
That's a dog
thing. Sounds like a dog's
thing. That's a dog.
So rumor has it, she was trying to drink the football captain at the time. What was his name? Willie Walker.
Willie Walker.
Willie Walker. She was trying to outdrink him. They had been a thing for a little while, and they were on again, off again. I think the alcohol helped him be on again. And
usually does.
And there was some smoking, and they were drinking the heavy stuff. I think there was a bottle of 151 they had out at that point. And people were not in good shape, and cigarette, and 151, and curtains, and they were lucky to get everybody out from what I heard. It went up pretty quick.
Wow.
Interesting. And nobody
That's
got
an astonishing level of detail that I have no idea what to do with.
That's what this guy does.
That's fantastic.
That's what this guy does.
I'm sure his name's like Cliff.
I drop a box of toothpicks.
Is he a post game?
287.
So that's what they found with their investigation. Nothing.
I think there were several eyewitness accounts. Obviously, I wasn't there. But several eyewitness accounts. The fraternities in the local area all took a little damage, but they've been. The place was closed for the next semester, and they had it rebuilt within, say, 6-8 months' time.
That's pretty
Whatever happened to Joy?
I told you, I don't know. I don't follow kids when they leave here.
All right.
She didn't become a political figure, if that's your meaning. My guess?
Joy,
she's in a trailer somewhere.
I'm looking for her Instagram account, but...
My guess is she's in a trailer somewhere with a third kid on the way.
How about Willie Walker? Did he ever make it?
No,
he
didn't make it.
He's a good player.
Yeah, he tore up his knee.
I remember he was a senior when I was a junior getting recruited here.
Yeah, tore up his knee.
He was
chop block in practice.
He got drafted. He tore up his knee during training camp. Never recovered.
Sounds like this place is almost cursed.
And that, Adam.
Cursed.
Is how you GM and not have anything to say.
That was amazing. That was an astonishing level of detail.
That's not in your book?
No.
Yeah, nice. I listened to that thing. I'm like, well, I don't know.
The only reason
paper.
I knew that before you said that is because I've been playing with you for so long.
Look at names.
We used to wear an onion on our belt.
Oh, yeah. Because
that was the style at the time.
So what else do you want to know, guys?
When the sorority house was rebuilt, was there anything? It's a lot bigger than it used to be, right?
Yeah, they made it a lot bigger. They did it right on the spot where the other one was. It went up really quick. I don't know how they got all the permits and everything and the plans all done pretty quickly. It may have been that Alpha Phi is a national sorority, so they may have a plan that they like to use for different. So they're all kind of the same.
I'm interested in the floor planning and I'm writing this article, where if I can get a floor plan of it so I can detail my accounts like you, I like details.
Well, son, from my perspective, if I was a young strapping lad like yourself, I would just go over there for a party and get myself some first-hand information. However, if you're more like your little friend here, and you're more comfortable with the book solution, you could probably go to town hall and get a record of the blueprints.
I think I like magazines better than books. But town hall, we can go.
Town hall? Oh boy, that sounds fun.
She's fantastic.
I can go find out about all the permits they offer.
Yeah. How long ago, like the back porches these days, are they permitted to stand 8 foot or is it down to 6 foot here in these
parts? Could be grandfathered in.
Yeah. This is great. I'll go to town.
Most of the stuff is about barbecue pits.
Hung low. Hung low. You want to go?
It's evening. You have to go to tomorrow. You have to go to the next day.
Let's do it tomorrow.
There's no party at the sorority house tonight?
Is there?
Joe Diffie, is there a party at that sorority house tonight?
There's a party at that sorority house every night.
Maybe Joe can get you into Beta Sigma. Beta Sigma to see if maybe you're interested in pledging there. You could help bring in, get to some, maybe you could find out some information or something.
That's Beta Sigma, this bad boy.
Amen.
Edison?
Joe, do your magic. Get him in the door.
Hey, Mr.
Edison, you're just coming. Come on.
Mr. Ronaldo, thank you very much.
Guys, I don't...
Come on. It's always nice talking to you.
Guys, it was my pleasure. It's always nice to talk to young people who are interested in history. Joel is weeping right now.
Right?
Yeah. And anytime you want to talk, please, by all means, come back and see me.
Don't come back now, you hear?
Thank you, Mr. Hidalgo. I hope that you enjoy your red hair tonight.
Nope.
He's at his third one.
Oh, what? We're not in Utah? That's just not right.
No, he's on his block now.
Guys, I'm not good at parties. I don't think I should go.
Don't worry. We'll take care of you.
I have some physics homework that I have to do, the extra credit part and the
extra credit part.
What's
well,
it do?
Well, there is physics
it's
involved.
It's not due until February, but I thought I'd get a joke.
Yeah, we need to talk about the effects of gravity on
a keg stand. It is the weirdest how alcohol can flow up. You'll see. It's fantastic.
I don't think I'm not.
I did hear that they have a high concentration of physics majors.
How many people can you get onto a blow up valve?
0%
without it popping. It's a physics question.
Maybe there's a balcony he can do the math to see how many people can support.
There you go.
Well, if there's somebody there, we can talk about the assignment that's due next week. I wouldn't mind that. I'd like some other perspectives on, you know, whether you account for air friction or you just do the calculation based on gravity alone.
It'd be PSI.
But I'm not good at talking to girls, you know this.
I think in general, Edison raises our chances of getting information and or lucky by like 100%.
I do?
You're easy.
Exactly.
You're better talking with us?
Yeah. Oh,
boy.
Oh, yeah.
We are in trouble.
I'm positive.
He's going to be the hurt puppy. Where are all the girls? Please help me.
Oh, you're so cute.
We're going to call the anchor.
Thanks.
She's going to drag us down.
Because I'm strong and I'm impervious.
You're our CB, buddy.
I'm the one that keeps the ship from moving on to places where it shouldn't go.
Exactly.
Guarding the ship.
You got to
I'm the anchor, guys. The anchor.
You should get that tattoo. The anchor tattoo right here.
Too.
The plane.
I can never get any incriminating marks.
Did you know Bob got a tattoo with the top one? That tattoo thing right there.
Yeah. Nice.
Yeah, I did.
Yeah.
I'll show you later.
Perfect.
No, shut up.
It's a butterfly with tough mutter.
It's a tough mutter. Here's the butterfly. Fabulous.
Edison would not get a tattoo for the same reason I would not get a tattoo.
I'm getting another tattoo.
If I ever decide to go to a life of crime, that's an identifying.
I'm getting a full arm.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
What caused this?
Midlife crisis.
Midlife crisis. No, I've always wanted it, so that's a good time.
What's your signal?
All right. I keep continuing. I got the picture right here. What I'm getting.
This is gonna be a better choice than your first choice.
Oh.
Better choice than your first choice.
Sorry.
In other words, the first one sucks.
No exit. I mean, no entrance. Oh, wait.
Right, that sounds like a pretty good one to me.
So you guys head back to the university?
Yes, we head back to the university.
All right. Missy's there. She's kind of frantic. She's like, finally left again. I followed her over there. She's inside, but I couldn't. They wouldn't. I'm afraid to go near them.
Listen, we're going to go over to Beta Sigma.
Oh. And what, get drunk?
Come with us.
I'm not going to that place.
We're gonna see if we can do a little recon.
The only hands are
out
on me are you right now.
What's that?
The only hands are out on me are you. And going in there.
I'll go in too.
Where you're gonna go?
We'll peek it over. We'll try to go upstairs and we'll be able to peek into their windows.
We're
gonna
sleep
like
that.
Sleepy
as whatever.
All right.
You sleep plus two.
Yeah. Oh, dear God.
So, you guys head on over to the fraternity?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. My sister said that was the most painful choice.
Chris, there's only two possible tattoos that I would ever get.
Yeah.
Cross my chest, press here, 30-1, or DNR.
Well, you better wait till next year, because it's just going to be 30. Scratch your breath. Yeah.
Yeah, right? No, they got rid of that. Apparently, breathing is really not required.
It's, yeah, they're getting rid of it next year.
They already did get rid of it.
Mikey, next year you're going to get tough mutter times two.
For the vice.
Yeah.
They're doing it for us, professionals.
No butterfly.
No butterfly. They actually used to have tattoo artists at the Tough Mutters. For people who finished, they would give them the tattoo if they wanted it.
Really?
We're going to give you a free drink after you've run 10 miles. Have another couple and come talk to me.
I feel like the headband is perfect. That's true. Right?
Yes.
Because, you know, I can take that off.
Yeah. All right.
Scratches that'll last a few days, but that's all.
All right, Joe, take them over.
All right, so we're going to head over to the frat house and see what's going on tonight.
Missy Jordan's
going
to help us get it.
Missy Jordan's coming along for the ride.
Guys, should
oh,
we...
No, that's for when we go upstairs.
Should we be changing our clothes? Is there... Joe Diffie, can you help me look cool?
Nope,
I want to look cool.
Edison, there isn't enough money in the world to make you look cool.
You look great.
The best thing you can do is just be yourself. That'll make me look cool.
Like this T-shirt that I have on with a picture of the Death Star from Star Wars Episode 7? That's cool, right?
No, chicks dig the Death Star.
Oh, all right.
It's not a Death Star versus the TARDIS?
It's also got the silhouette of Jar Jar Binks on the other side.
No, Jar Jar Binks.
No, burn that shirt.
No.
Oh, why do I let you wear it? Oh, wait.
He's my favorite. I love him.
Busch Gardens. And his dad had the old school Star Trek Enterprise shirt. I was like, oh, guys, you have no idea what I could do. You better treat me nice, or else. Old school Doctor Who.
You were in Williamsburg?
Yeah.
I didn't realize that. I thought my sister in law was there.
Really?
So let's go to
Beta Sigma.
All right, it's knocking the door.
All right. Oh, Mike, Joe Diffie knows some people there.
Oh.
He's, Joe Diffie and Trout, Joel's character, are legacies. Their fathers are both former members of this
family. No, I think Edison had a father who was here somewhere.
And Trout's the moneymaker, right?
I thought it was just Trout.
I was the number two.
No, it was Trout. I know that.
Oh, Trout and me.
Trout's dad was a legacy. Yeah. And owns a oil company.
Yeah.
Oh, right.
Trout's a good friend to have.
Yeah,
he buys things a lot.
He's built like so many of the buildings on campus.
Did he build this? Can we get the plans for this?
I don't think that it's ever built the Alphi Phi.
It's
why they donated the money to have them built.
So Joe Diffie takes you over there. Joe, take it to us.
Joe, what do we got, Mr. Diffie?
All right, so we once we get there, I give the secret knock.
It's not nearly as nice as the Alphi Phi house, by the way.
It's dirty. It smells like stagnant beer.
What, Mikey?
Definitely not as nice as the Alpha House.
Hey, Joe Diffie, did you notice that your secret knock is the first three numbers that are prime numbers? That's very interesting.
As a matter of fact, Edison, I did notice that.
Wow.
One, two, three.
The reason we use that is because there's not that many smart people on this campus.
Wow.
All right, so Joshua opens the door.
A guy you don't recognize. You kind of see him. And Warren is there.
Oh, Warren's there?
Yeah, Warren opens the door.
All right, great.
Joe,
so,
good to see
ya. You know, hey, Warren.
How's it going? Where's your awkward friend?
Which awkward one? I got a whole group with me tonight.
The legacy you usually bring around.
Oh, you mean Trout?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, he's a little indisposed this evening. I decided to leave him home. Figured it'd be better for all of us. I brought some of my other friends over. Everybody, this is Warren. He's the Pledge Master here at Beta Sigma.
Hi, Warren.
Hi, gentlemen. My name is
Warren Moon.
Is Warren Gutierrez. Nice to meet you all. Shake all your hands. What was your name? Ooh, football player.
Johnny Moon.
Johnny, I heard.
Oh, yeah, this is Johnny.
We have a place here for a guy like you here.
Wando Montgomery.
With a name like that, I'm not going to forget that.
You call me Wando.
Sure,
all right, Monty.
Sure, Wani.
Tell him your name.
It's okay, son.
This is a man.
It's okay, bud.
Oh, that's a guy?
Yeah, this is a guy. This is Warren. He's the Pledge Master for Beta Sigma.
Hi, I'm Edison. Nice to meet you.
He looks at Joe Diffie and goes, is this the smart one?
This is the one I was telling you about.
So we might want him to help us with our homework?
Exactly.
Nope.
Guys, I'm right here. I can hear you.
Well, if you'd been in here with music, you wouldn't hear me. Because I can barely hear you.
Oh, all right.
Who's this guy? He points at
Ford Perfect's the name. Can you guess where I was born?
Before
Mars?
In a Ford.
I thought you'd be conceived in a Ford.
I'm conceived in a Ford, yeah.
Same one?
It's a conceived and born in a Ford.
Yeah, Ford Fairlane. This is him right here.
And it was perfect.
So anyway, what's going on tonight, Warren? Anything good?
We got, it's Thursday night, so we got Thursday night football on.
All right.
And,
we might have
a keg or two tap. You know,
it's Texas. Even you and I are into football here.
You at least know the team names. And,
you know whose costumes are whose.
So a bunch of us watching the game. We got a few guys chugging out some homework. Poor guys.
What subject is this? The physics? Because this dude can help.
I was going to say, what do they got? Edison might be interested in having some helping with some physics stuff. He's looking to do some extra credit stuff anyway.
Really?
Edison, exactly.
Let's go for a walk. And he puts his arm around Edison.
Oh, boy.
Takes him into a back, around through a couple rooms.
Away from the kegs.
You hear Edison's voice fading in the distance. You're not the nice guy, Warren.
And Warren is barely keeping a straight line.
It was nice knowing you, Edison. Bye-bye now.
And he brings you in. There's a couple guys looking bleary-eyed at laptops. Looks like they're trying to do some coding. And Edison, do you know anything about programming this stuff?
Program? Well, let's see what you got here.
Are you legally allowed to do any programming?
Oh, is that Mr. Masevich's Fortran 101? Oh, look, you didn't end your...
All right, well, we're going to be in the front room if you need us.
Here, let me just
tell you.
Boy's
going to be talking.
Edison looks happier than a pig in the
kitty. Looking at something.
The rest of you guys go in there, and there's a dozen guys. Half of them are already unconscious from alcohol. There's some stale pizza on the bar. Help yourselves.
Somebody say, have a beer. It don't cost nothing.
Have a beer, have some pizza. It's not us tonight, guys.
Hey, where are the chicks, man?
It's football night. Chicks are here tomorrow night for the party. Actually, tomorrow night's the big street fair kind of party, so everybody's going to be out tomorrow night.
All right.
Is that why everybody's being so secretive, like over at the Alpha Phi house?
What do you mean by secretive?
Oh, you haven't seen that? They get the pledges, and they huddle them in, and they don't let nobody in. They don't let nobody know what's going on.
That's not secret. That's what we all do.
That's kind of the whole idea of a Ferrari and a fraternity.
Ferrari and a fraternity?
Ferrari and a fraternity.
We haven't all officially announced our pledges yet, but I think they've almost finalized their list. You guys are kind of late to the game here, but, if you're interested, Joe Diffie here, he's been a pretty stand-up guy for us so far. He's been helping us with some pharmacological needs we have. And,
like California and the
agricultural. We're always happy to have a star athlete. That boy in the other room, everybody has their place. I'm not so sure about you, Chad, man.
We got nothing.
Call me one low.
Okay, Wani.
So, how long's he been there?
Not here.
I walk over to the keg, fill up a cup, bring it over to Johnny Moon, bring one over to Juan Lowe.
Thank you.
Juan Lowe, this beer has been blessed by the Lord himself.
I remember in history class.
It was brewed with holy water.
Somebody once said that beer proved that God loves us and wants us to be happy. So by drinking the beer, I do God work.
That's it. You know, in all seriousness, they didn't drink the water back then anyway, so all they had was beer.
Yeah, it was safer to drink the beer because it would boil for an hour.
Exactly.
So what do you do for it? What's your major here?
Well, I'm a journalistic major. I do a lot of research. My new school newspaper.
So you kind of know things before the rest of people know things that happen sometimes, huh?
Sometimes I do catch wind of things that do happen. I hear you guys having a good time. wrote an article about you last week. Very good article, I might say, about your rush pledges. I'm excited to see who's going to be your new pledges. But we're doing a little research right now on the fires. Matter of fact, that happened in Alpha Phi a little while ago. We're trying to dig up some good, juicy dirt. It's a six-year anniversary coming up, and I figured we'd have a good story there.
Really?
Had the big fire at the... Birds, what was it called?
The Nest.
The Nest?
The Roost.
The Roost?
And the fire at Alpha Phi.
The Roost fire, that was pretty... That was something. I heard some good stories about it. But wait, didn't I hear that you guys were instrumental in keeping everybody bringing people out of the building?
Yeah, we say we did.
Joe never ceases to stop talking about that.
Yeah, we seem to have something to do with that, that's for sure.
He said he single-handedly...
How many people did he carry on his back?
He wore
my back still hurts from carrying all those people out.
It's like Forrest Gump.
And then I couldn't find my friend, so I had to go back again.
Stinging him up.
A big cheer erupts in the background. Something's happened in the game. Something good.
So what can you tell us about the fire? You mind if I take some notes? Intro, do you know anything?
Well, I wasn't here back then.
Yeah, but, you know, rumors, stories passed down.
We might have some... some archives material as to what happened.
Huh. Mind if I take a peek at it?
Did you guys have any damage from the fire being so close?
Yeah, you can see if you come out. If you go outside, you see this, he opens up, there's a slide door. Kind of takes you out there. See this deck, the deck, some stuff fell here. So we rebuilt the deck much bigger, nicer, with the jacuzzi in back then.
I go up there, I'm looking at it, but I'm looking next door to the,
we want to see the backyard of the Alpha Phi house.
Huge deck.
As you can see, there's lights on the side, girls walking back and forth. Some
must have under your deck.
Not necessarily clad in what you would consider modest. Well, like, people can fit out of the deck, but I don't know. Joe Dibby's immediately thinking,
are there any pillow
fights?
Candy
rain!
What up?
Are any of them engaged in pillow fights?
Not that you can see. Tell.
Okay.
You throw a pillow their way. Hey! Suggestion!
It's like here to the neighbor. So you're, you know, it's a good 30, 40
feet. So even binoculars, really.
Yeah. Not binoculars, but you can get the impression of people. So.
Huh. So the fire was that hot that it burnt your deck.
Actually, what happened was some of the, there was a gas line in there. Part of that exploded, blew some stuff over here that caught on the deck.
Well, from what I can gather, and let me read my notes, Joy Hines was partying a little bit too much. That's what the rumor has, and that's what I can get from the papers, but you all know we make things up.
With Willie Walker. Was he a fraternity?
Willie Walker was a legacy here.
Was he?
His pappy was here. He was here. There was good people.
It was a shame about him in the NFL.
Yep. Blew up his knee. But don't worry. He was a member of the fraternity. He has a nice job now working. It's all about who you know sometimes, you know? It's all about who you know. Edison's already done. He comes back. They were like, it was child's play.
Guys, and that's why 8% of the world's currency today does not physically exist. It is actually just stored inside of computers.
Do we have any of that currency, Edison?
Well,
flowing our way, taking pennies from, you know, rounding up.
What, like the theme of Superman 3? What, Richard Pryor did that? Or do you mean like the theme in Office Space, which those guys did that?
Touche.
Right. You know, and guys, one last thing. Before you finish that Fortran homework, just remember, Tron in 1982 was forbidden from getting nominated for any sort of special effects awards because they thought using computers was cheating. I know. Amazing, right? Thanks very much, guys. I'll see you next Tuesday. Guys, that was fun. I made a lot of friends.
You stinking.
I told you you'd like this over here, Edison, didn't
yeah,
I?
That is true, by the way.
No kidding.
Yeah. They should have gotten the award for special effects, but they thought
totally.
It is cheating.
So, you wanted to...
Look what George Lucas did with it.
Let's head on down to the archive room.
All right, let's go down. This is going to get good.
And now what I'm about to show you guys, we don't show to just everybody. Now this is kind of one of the benefits of being a member.
Membership has its privileges.
Membership has its privileges.
He's not showing us his massive debt, is he?
So he takes you down to the basement.
What?
Opens
I'm
up a.
I'm kind of intimidated by his huge debt.
Secret room.
He opens up a room in the basement, and there's just file cabinets all over the place and a computer. Well, we're slowly working on digitizing this. Maybe somebody would be interested in helping us if the time were to come about.
Oh.
But here you have all the. And he's showing off at this point. He opens the drawer. Here's all the physics midterms and finals from 1985 to current, based on professor, level, yada yada. Closes out. Here's this one. It's like everything that Joe Diffie could ever need to never have to study.
Sanskrit.
Which is exactly why Joe Diffie's a plague.
Here's
that. That's like, do you know, I could probably build a database that would predict with a high percentage of likelihood what questions will be on the next test for specific professors in a given year?
Really?
There's probably a couple guys here that you could talk to about that.
Wow.
Let me just throw it out there.
That would be a fun project.
Or
totally useless.
We can just study.
So we're going to skip all this stuff about academics.
Perfect.
He walks past, floor to ceiling file cabinets, and he comes over to. So here we have some of the archives of the building.
Huh.
And he's leafing through, and he's able to show you some of the fire damage that happened. And you can see in the background, just the fraternity house is just utterly just cindered and collapsed in. And nothing left.
Nobody got hurt.
What started that fire, by the way? That's a terrible fire.
Who told you nobody got hurt?
Well, that's the...
We saw no one got killed, we thought.
No one got killed.
That I've heard. I can't substantiate that because I wasn't there.
Nobody got killed from two sources. A reliable one source. But who got hurt?
Well, all kinds of people got hurt. People got trampled getting out. People got burned. It was a firefighter that got hurt pretty bad trying to get...
smoke inhalation?
No, he got scarred up pretty good.
Oh.
He was a volunteer, and he ran in there without his stuff on, trying to help a young lady. And he did help her, but he was horribly scarred in the process.
Joey Behinds?
Travis Gilbert. He was a brother here until he graduated.
What does he have now? Is he okay?
I think he's a fire inspector now somewhere.
Oh,
okay.
Hey, it's okay. Let me get a little something. Let me get a little something.
So, anyway, so here's some. Here's a couple pictures of the house as it was after the fact.
That seems like a really hot fire to burn the house.
Yeah.
So,
from what I understand back then, the brewery wasn't open, so there was a lot more hard liquor involved. So things burned a little quicker
too.
With that.
But sounds like you're skeptical on what exactly happened.
Dude, I've been here for 4 years. I've been here for 4 years. I might graduate another couple.
I've been here for 8 years. I've been out of the school for 7 years. I'm no dummy.
I know what's going on here.
I've seen shit that would turn you white. I just like this, this is East Texas University. It ain't always what it appears to be.
Tell us about it, huh?
So, I don't have much more to show on this, unfortunately.
Anybody got any more questions?
Here's a couple pictures of it as they were building it, but nothing in detail.
Nothing I can see?
Yeah. It's,
do you mind if I take a picture of those pictures on my phone?
Be my guest, but you can get them here.
Thanks. Edison snaps a couple of shots.
Sure.
Make a good journal set, Edison.
With the time, date, and GPS tag.
I'll take that as a very high compliment. Thank you very much, Ford. Wow.
So what do you think happened? You sound like you don't believe the official reports. Do you got any idea what really happened?
Oh no, I suspect that there was certainly some drunken debauchery that caused the fire. Now, whether there was something else involved, I don't know.
Did you hear any rumors? Was there anything fun going on there or strange going on there?
You know what I'm talking about. There's always the rumors, the behind the scenes stuff that, you know, people.
You mean
just
like those two girls in the corner?
What?
Two girls who share the corner room?
Yeah. Yeah, just, you know, the rumors. You know, the crazy
things. If you're into that stuff, go upstairs, find Al.
What?
He's got some binoculars set up. It's all yours.
Guys, I'm going to do a little journalistic view. Anybody want to partake?
What are you doing? We have a case.
I am investigating.
That's not hiring us.
What kind of services, like service, community service, do you guys really focus on here at Vegas Sigma?
We work on making sure our boys pass.
Everybody graduates.
No one really wants
that. I thought I had a decent question.
But no, we are. Being more of a local fraternity, we're focused on contributing to the school. We have several architecture majors who are helping in the redesign of the roost, some engineering majors who are working on the electrical systems and that kind of stuff. So we try to give back to the school in any manner we can.
Nice.
Sounds like you guys keep busy.
Keep our hands in stuff sometimes.
I just meant there's always a lot of work to be done rebuilding around here.
It does seem to be that way. What was your major, sir?
Architecture.
Oh, really? So maybe we could find a place for you then.
Gee, thanks.
You know, any friend of Joe's is a friend of mine so far. Nerdboy over
Trout.
Here.
Trout? No, we're still working on Trout. The jury's still out on Trout. But he's a legacy.
Trout's got a lot of money. We like him.
That's because let me guess, he feeds you.
He feeds us well.
And he eats a lot too.
Yeah, he was pretty impressive when we had the fire alarm chili the other day.
Oh, you had fire alarm chili here?
We had. Then he showed up.
How was it, like, Ma's Kitchen? Is that the name of the place?
Ma's Diner or something like that.
Yeah, the chili place.
Yeah, well, we don't talk about where we got it from. It's supposed to be made here. It was part of the chili contest that the different fraternities and sororities had.
Oh. I just because the stuff at Mars so good. The fire chili, the red fire chili, oh, so good.
I think you're having trouble with your English. I think, Hung, you mean so bad. I think you mean bad.
No,
the opposite.
It was no good for you, but it was good to me.
No, horrible.
Oh, I love this stuff. Remind me of my Szechuan back home.
It's terrible. Well, I'm trying to forget those days.
I don't get to eat it a whole lot like back home, you know, here in Texas. You guys all like the sweet stuff and your barbecue.
So what's your interest next door? Somebody looking for a certain girl or something? Because you know I don't have a map, but I'm sure I can tell you what room certain women are in.
Miranda?
You know what? My girlfriend's friend is
her your girlfriend's roommate.
Yeah, roommate. This pleasure just says like she's not the same since she's been pleasure. Just kind of dopey, stressed out, like, just not the same fun loving that she was when
Let's
she started.
Let's just say she's acting weird.
Yeah, I know there's a lot of pressure when you're...
Yeah, you know, they tend to burn them up for, they don't give them a lot of sleep time sometimes, keeping them busy with their do-good works sorority, sit around in the community, feeding the homeless.
Wait. Fighting over you.
Chris is starting catfights over here.
Your girlfriend came out, and then boom, this other one.
Whack.
I don't know. Yeah. I don't know about this one.
Lola thinks she owns the house. She's been here for 3 weeks. She thinks it's her house.
When she got out of the cat here, she just laid all across the floor. That was it. She didn't go running high. She just, yeah, I'm here. That's it.
She was a waitress.
Showgirl. All right, so, gentlemen, is there anything else I can do for you? Because I do have some more pledge duties I have to take care of.
Show us where the beer and stale pizza is, and we will hang out till the party.
That's tomorrow.
You guys?
It's tomorrow. It's Thursday night.
We will drink until Thursday night. Drinks on you.
Wait a minute. It's Thursday night. Tonight's party night in College Town.
Let's go find something to do, boys.
All right. So you're going to stick around for a few beers and a pizza?
I should be doing homework.
Bless you. Good. Shut up now.
Is this part of
the...
Is this a character or is this...
No.
Does it say to the moose here?
Is Warren sneezing right now?
No.
What the hell is going on?
So, you guys stick around for the party?
Yeah.
think he's allergic to something.
Well, you're sticking around for the game for a while.
Yeah,
hang
sure.
out, get to know the boys a little bit.
Good pizza and beer, and heck, you can watch turn that down.
Absolutely.
Although I think Edison's going to tell us about the etymology of the word beer and the ancient practices of the brewing of beer.
So close! Sorry, Chris.
No, it's cool. Well, you're not used to anybody being in that chair.
No, nobody's supposed to be in that chair.
Welcome,
I threw a tissue
welcome
in my feet.
Back.
It went by Chris's ear, landed on the top
what
of the couch,
backwards.
And came back onto the shoulder.
No one was listening to the audio.
Well,
gosh,
we appreciate the show. Chris, it was great seeing you.
I tried to toss it in the trash and it landed on the couch. Thanks to the beat. Oh,
so, I'm going to use some water. Yeah.
So Warren comes in after a while, calls Joe Diffie away. Joe Diffie comes back about 30 minutes later. He is lit. Joe is providing, I think, maybe sampling some of those special pharmaceuticals. That
Joe Diffie.
Joe was able to provide.
I've been grown in back.
So. Game ends.
He's home game. Team one.
Home team one. Which was good for you guys in this case.
Say too bad Dallas or Houston was away. I guess we'd be Houston fans.
Yeah, I guess so. Sure.
Houston Texans. I know my sports ball. Sports ball.
So, all right. So, I assume you guys head back to the dorm at that point.
We stumble back.
Missy's a little pissed off at you. She left partway through the game, Jeff.
But there was football and beer.
I thought you were helping me.
I'm going deep and undercover in the character and repeat something.
Oh, well, that's okay.
I'll see you tomorrow.
Well, tonight then, you can spend the night on your own tonight.
Should I just come by for a total sleepover or just have
Clay
too? No, you'll just sleep in your own room.
Yeah, but before the sleeping.
I'll see you later on.
Yeah.
I'm good there.
Maybe tomorrow if you help me for real.
John and Moon, why do you guys have sleepovers so much? Like, what do you have, movie marathons? Is that what you're watching? If you are, I might recommend Buckaroo Banzai and Remo Williams, The Adventure Returns.
Begins,
yeah.
Maybe you guys could show Wanlow Indiana Jones.
I don't want to watch a movie.
Yeah, maybe the three of you should watch Indiana Jones.
Watch him whip. Watch him nay-nay. You know what? Oh, shut up.
All right, so.
I'll live in a goddamn under a rock. Anyway, go ahead.
Is it modern pop music? Is that what you're referring to?
Yeah.
That's
yeah, forget about it.
Continue, go. All
right, so night passes uneventfully. You all wake up feeling pretty hungover, except for maybe Edison, who has just got the contact high from whatever else is smoking in the house.
I feel kind of weird, guys.
He's just breathing in the alcohol.
He's breathing in the fumes from you guys.
Weird. That's a weird, weird. That's a great word. Weird.
What?
You ever notice if you say the word elbow about 30 times, it loses its meaning? What's up with that?
Elbow.
All right, so Johnny Moon does not have practice today.
Oh. I do have class. Sorry.
You can stop that.
I have to work a little bit.
Never play it again.
All right, you guys have your class. You guys have your classes in the morning.
Sorry.
Okay, no music like that's allowed to game.
That's whip
it. Unless it's part of it.
Watch me whip.
Okay,
good. So your morning classes, because your late morning classes. It is Friday, so you have late morning classes and no afternoon, because that's how college students schedule their stuff.
Except
Edison has a 7:30.
Class.
I
think the head class
lab.
Is
7:30.
Optional.
Optional.
Edison was in the lab.
He's auditing.
He's auditing. All right, so did you want to head back to town, try to get those plans? What was your scoop for the day?
Yeah.
Guys, I am ready to go. Let's go to City Hall. This is going to be so fun.
I'm
going to
head there. Edison.
Yeah.
You're my junior journalist.
I am.
Maybe we will head there and do
maybe
it.
Maybe we should split.
Yes, sir.
Walk, face,
we
and go.
Did you hear what they said, Mikey? Go ahead.
Yeah.
Maybe we should split the party.
We split and go to the party. Or they go to town hall.
We're going to head to town hall.
All right. Is the group going? Or the rest
yeah,
of the
we're
in?
All out, though.
All right, so you're heading into town.
I'm going to my work study.
Like
I'll still participate in this going
yeah.
to town hall.
So your work study is making sure that the new decimal numbers at the library don't move.
I gotta check people into the gym.
All right, so they
one person, because you know that's how it is.
So you head on over to the city hall.
Yep.
And then
I'm gonna look up and ask him. I'm gonna say, hey, you know, we're interested in seeing if we can look up the plans for the new Alpha Phi house. I'm doing a story, you know, coming up on the 6-year anniversary.
Before and after.
Yeah, before and after, and the progression, and it's a really in-depth story.
He's also investigating the fire because one of our friends is acting kind of weird.
Puts his hand over at his mouth.
Is that the weird one?
That's the weird one we told you about.
Oh, okay.
This guy here, as I slap in the back.
Oh, okay. It's a minor.
All right, you head on down to the clerk before
yeah.
I charge a few bucks to print if you want to print them out.
Excellent. Yeah, no problem. Thanks very much. We'll go down to clerk.
We'll read it. We'll pay for it.
Ashley's planning zone. Sorry, heading out of planning zone.
Yeah.
Out to lunch. Oh,
yeah. As always.
Out to lunch from 11 to 3.
Please check back later.
So. All right, so there's an old cantankerous old woman there.
Oh.
What can I do for you, boys?
What's her name?
Shirley. Edith.
Does she have a name tag?
No.
Oh.
She refuses to wear it. But there's a little plaque on the desk.
It says Edith.
Yeah.
Edith. So nice to meet you.
Oh, what do you want, Sonny? You're not sweet talking to me.
Oh, damn it. Persuasion rolls.
But that boy over there, he's pretty cute.
Edison.
What?
Just saying.
Hi, young man. Isn't that cute? He's tongue-tied.
I put my hand in his back. We are looking for the branch for the...
Plants.
For the fire.
For the fire.
Alpha Phi, 6 years ago. That's
from a long time ago.
Because we're doing a paper.
Because.
Hey, Sereno. What do you want?
We're looking to see if we get the plans for the Alpha Phi. We're doing a paper, and I'm going to be in a local paper about the 6-year fire, and we're wondering if we can just get some more information.
All right, well, I need to see some ID that you're with the press.
No problem. I show my journalistic press pass. I show my junior press pass from where I was before.
I really don't care about your high school press pass.
Show my press pass.
Or your middle school press pass.
You have a lot of press passes, I've noticed there, Corey.
I'm in the press.
She's kind of putting us inside the box. She has stuck on her head. All right, so she disappears for about 10 or 15 minutes.
I'm watching you.
Just what do you
always
think?
Always
she's
watching.
Gone to lunch or died back there. You're not really sure which one.
She's don't die.
Ford, she kind of reminds me of a sister of Homer Simpson's wife. I'll be back.
All right, so I need $5 to show you the plants, because $5 effort for me to get them.
Oh, elephant ears. Elephant ears, get it? Nobody?
$5. Here you go.
Thank you, young man.
What the
heck? Do you see her?
What is that cat doing?
Mike, we have a tissue box where the sides are off.
Picture.
It's empty. The little cat has crawled into the tissue box and her head is out of the tissue part.
That's a door plug-in.
My wife sent me that. That's very funny.
Nope, you can't get
away. She stuck me out. I don't know.
Oh, that is
out.
Fantastic.
You should do video. I love how she's playing the whole, no, I really wanted to be in here,
Hank. Kidding.
Now she's just stuck in the mic. All right, so the,
That's cute. Yes, we're laughing at you.
Oh.
Did you get it?
I'm running out of battery.
Yeah. You just lost your battery.
Are you?
So she provides the plans. She lays the plans out. She goes, all right, you can take pictures of them, or if you want copies, it's $10 a sheet.
Yeah, we're going to make some copies.
Okay.
$10 a sheet.
It's a plot.
Oh.
It's a full size blueprint plot, so it's $10 a sheet.
Did it lose it?
Edison, take pictures. $10 a sheet, too much. That's pure money.
Can I just take pictures of it instead? That way we'll save the city hall some ink and some paper.
That's fine.
Thank you, babe.
Okay, so here's the first floor. And she showed you the first floor plan.
Oh, click.
And here's the second floor.
Hey, what kind of camera is that there? Isn't
the plan says there should be a basement, but I don't see the basement plan here.
So I'm pulling a Jeff. I apologize.
Not bad. Not bad, my friend. What's the lens?
Extreme zoom, buddy.
That's a massive what?
It's a massive deck that Warren has.
We're just comparing cameras. Want to see my zoom lens?
Warren's.
I don't know if you can read that or not, Mike.
Warren's deck is huge.
No, I can't.
No, I had to take some pictures.
All right, so she's able to show you the first and second floor, but she says there should be a basement sheet that she doesn't have. It's missing.
Oh.
That's not uncommon. That happens all the time.
The old basement sheet. Did they use the same basement as the old house? You know, I don't know.
I think somebody told me it was bigger, so maybe they used part of it.
What's your name? Love?
Eat it.
Is the house next door, is there the plans for that house? Maybe they're built in the same manner.
They're different.
Two different houses.
Oh, all right. Do you have any other Alphi for other university?
What are you writing out?
The text of that thing from Mike so he doesn't miss out.
So if you'll...
You can screenshot it.
So if you scroll out, if you zoom out, you can see this is the main floor.
Oh, look at the spiral staircase.
Wow.
Nice.
Wow. It's a nice spot.
This is an actual sorority house at Florida State University for Alpha Phi.
Wow.
Are those girls too hot?
Yep.
They're very nice from
Whoever has the mouse can zoom out. Yeah.
You can use the mouse and I'll type.
Oh, yeah, once he clicks, you're in trouble.
I don't know these mice.
Oh boy, wrong way, Captain.
What else we got?
What the heck are those things? Those long
tables?
Ship
tables.
How many do you need?
Cafeteria.
I'd say that's seating for.
That's in a house.
Four, six.
Seating
eight,
for like 80.
10, 12, each 14 times.
Eight?
Somebody's good at math, do that.
Just a lot of hot chicks eating at a table.
Yeah.
There you go.
All right.
106.
So, that is the main floor.
116. All right.
And the second floor.
Look, that first floor looks like a person there. See in the bottom of the mouth? Is that how you
112.
If you zoom out, you can see the second floor there. This is primarily bedrooms.
112.
112.
Are there even 112 beds?
No, it's more space for guests, I guess. 10,
23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28,
it's like 20 bedrooms.
Is there a third floor?
So maybe there's three girls per bedroom.
Is there a third floor?
Oh, and if...
Not according to the plan.
And it is true that if you are a new pledge, like you're going to go in next year, you switch over your meal plan to there.
Yeah, maybe not everybody would live there.
Right, and you still live in a dorm or something.
Huh.
So.
There you go, Mike. I typed it out for you. What I was trying to show you.
So all right, so. Anything else, boys?
You've been fantastic. Edison, want to give her your number?
What side are we on?
Just in case she has any other, information.
My
address? No, I'm kidding you.
Oh,
God,
thank God.
Okay. You are to the right of the house. So I'll move back to the first deck so you can see.
I put
there's
this
a big sun deck there on the right, Jeff? Back right?
Yeah, with my journalist, I can put things in memory.
Like, commit it to memory?
Correct.
Yeah.
Big
the
right
front
there.
Is at the bottom?
The front is the bottom. It's the front porch.
The front is the top.
No, Adam scrolled. Yes,
yeah, so this is the back. This is
that's
the
back.
The back.
That's the sun deck right there where you're watching the girls' bathe. So they're off to the right.
front
porch.
The front
deck.
Of the house.
Yes.
Front porch.
You got all that, Mikey?
Got it.
Sure.
So,
I want to go to Florida State and just see if that's real.
Just Google, that's right. I Googled sorority house floor plans, got this, And it says right on the plan, Alpha Phi House, and there's a...
Yeah, I saw that, yeah.
And then I just Googled that, and I got the front of it.
Have you had any drones?
You never question why he's Googling, you know, women from Alpha Phi.
There might be some meteorology
over at that bar.
Actually, the creepiest thing I ever Googled was a six-year-old girl.
That little girl, yeah.
Was it cute?
I saw Stevie doing it.
So fun.
Was it a cute six-year-old girl?
Yeah, I was really good. I felt skinny. I felt okay, though, when it said stock photo. It's like, I'm not the only person looking at this.
You should have rerouted your IP address through
Bob.
The NSA knows anyway. We could always go to Walmart and pick one up on a credit card, use it, and then return it.
What are you talking about, return a drone?
Right.
So it's now 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Party starts the party starts at 7, but it doesn't really start.
Guys, I got an idea.
Edison's party starts at 7. Everybody else starts when they get there.
We need to pregame. All right?
Oh, God.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, you have a game plan in advance.
Correct. Let's all get together.
Pre-game.
Let's meet at the bar. Pregame.
All right. And what are we going to do?
Let's pay for beers.
Thank you.
Before we don't have to pay for beers. Oh,
where's
Trout? Nah.
Trout's under the weather for the night.
Yeah, damn it.
Is his credit card under the weather for the night?
Is it?
Tell him we got pizza. He can get pizza.
I don't know about the parties that she went to, but it was really actually hard to get drunk at frat party at where I went to college.
Your girlfriend's there,
because
right?
You'd get a beer, you could get in line, go back, get in line again, drink your beer while you're in line, and still be waiting 20 minutes to fill up your cup before you were done.
Fill up your cup? You know, where are your only cans?
Oh,
you couldn't have a party with any glass. You couldn't have a party with open by cans, open cups.
Oh, this is all off campus.
Yeah.
So, all right. So, is there a plan?
About 4 hours.
Looking at the plans, you see some notations about security systems, motion sensor, cameras, sensors on the windows.
Guys, you know there's motion sensors and security cameras in this thing. That's some very expensive pieces of equipment in here.
Is there any way we can tap into the camera system?
Well, it's a whole lot
no,
better.
No, no, I'm saying for
roof,
we have
home.
To for purposes of
research.
Research. Researching that ass. How could you ever get tired of that ass?
I don't feel comfortable the way you talk about me like that. Yeah. I have to say. I feel very objectified.
So, guys, what is the game plan for tonight?
Well, we could... Joe Diffie, he just blends right in. Maybe he moves in through the front door with a few of you. And then those of us who are perhaps less socially acceptable, perhaps we can be waiting in the wings and assisted from behind the scenes.
I already got varsity time. I'm accepted, trust me.
Like, maybe there's a window to the basement. Let's
start
getting to the basement window.
Anything on the floor plans that we notice, because I can't see it right here, that basement stairs?
Yes.
We got anything?
Adam, if you scroll down just
what's
a little bit.
What's lift? Is that a...
They're just stairs.
Lift means elevator. That's
yeah.
British word.
Yeah, I'm just saying, lift, is that an elevator to downstairs?
Is there any, what's it called, dead waiters?
Dumb waiters.
Dumb waiters?
Well,
there's
the kitchen's
stairs.
Over here, so there'd be no reason.
Part of the plan is
there's a
stairs.
Kitchen and a serving line. Hmm. So that probably is an actual, like, you know, for disabled people. People with disabilities.
Those
and the plans that say anything about, you know, let's study the plans. Any doors wired for security?
Maybe we could walk around back and
kind of study it.
There's just notes about a security system. You're not even sure it's installed.
It was just
on a plan. Doesn't mean it was done.
Yeah. And we're trying to figure out about this girl, why she's so nutty.
Well, if we go
your girlfriend's roommate, okay?
Well, we could go in and then create a distraction, which would allow some of us to go in the basement.
What's her major?
What's your major, minor?
Her girlfriend's roommate.
Undeclared.
If it's English, we'll just say it's normal.
Undeclared.
English, what?
General studies.
Liberal arts.
There it is, liberal arts. That's what I was looking for.
Oh, boy.
Right now. She hasn't figured it out yet.
She'll be freshman?
If it is, then it's just normal for her.
Flake out.
Bob, what's your major?
Are you asking him for real, or are you asking Edison's name?
No, your ratings are for real.
It was newspaper journalism and a second major in political science and a minor in economics and a minor in PR.
So you did a double major and a double minor?
Yeah. I came in with a lot of AP credits.
You did. But that's it. I said that was enough.
If I ever feel like I'm getting too big for my britches as far as intelligence, I'm glad I've got you guys.
You're a cheater.
You still got to put in the thing. It is you can't graduate early.
Yeah.
But you still have to put in your 4 years.
We had a friend Eric. He skipped his entire. He had up AP to get his first freshman semester done.
Yeah.
He didn't have to do the freshman semester. But.
What that does is it opens up to make minors easier.
Yeah, but he's only a brain surgeon now, right?
He threw his life away and became a lawyer.
He's studying molecular
biology. Like Pop wanted to do.
You're talking Aaron. I said Eric.
Oh, Eric. Oh, I thought you meant Jerry Pollock.
No. I'm friends with Aaron.
He's working on the things for Alzheimer and stuff. Molecular biologist.
Yeah. So, anyway, back to the game. Because it's already 10:30.
Yes.
Because it's already 10:30. We're doing good. We're treading water just right now. All right,
let's get to the party, boys.
But how are you going to get to the basement? That's what you want to see.
I've got my camera and journalism stuff on because
I was
going in as
the,
going in as a
because we could create a
I
want to
take pictures of naked women.
I know they're not going
to do that.
Damn it!
Cause them to evacuate. You could do a distraction so people could slip into the basement while the distraction was going on.
Have
you ever watched Mission Impossible from 1970 through 1979? It's a lot of good ideas.
What mission? What's impossible?
Well, it's a group of five or six friends, specially skilled, each with their unique talents and personalities.
Is this 18?
Every week, they're given a mission that is impossible to complete. And then,
why are they doing missions if they're impossible to complete? If it's impossible, you don't do it.
Because they're so good that they complete the mission anyway.
So a mission is impossible.
But not one person could do it. It's impossible for one person. But together as a team.
It's the IMF team. The Impossible Mission Force team.
You bet the clouds.
There is no I in team, my friends. But there's an M and an E.
Impossible, and you give up. No, you rise to the occasion, and you fight, and then
I got you. No.
Remember back when we were in that cave?
Getting the good one.
Sacrifices surrounded by deadly dogs.
Oh, well, I kill all the dogs.
That's right. That was not Mission Impossible. That was Mission Impossible.
Yeah, that was possible because I killed all the dogs.
Well, yeah, you did save
all the dogs. And a couple of zombies, too.
Yeah, that's true. You killed pretty much everyone. You bet.
Joe, I assume you don't have your gun. Oh, it's Texas, maybe.
No. I am not bringing my gun to the sorority party.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Well, actually, it's more like a Greek festival, so all the fraternities and sororities on the road have stuff going on.
All the houses are technically open for the party.
Did you just shoot it right out of the bottle?
No,
Two fingers,
he was trying to put the cap on while still holding the beer, and it was kind of tilting, and it was very focused, just tapped it on top of it.
So, night comes.
But we are taking that weird Aztec symbol with us, though. We don't want to leave it in the dorm and then have it get stolen, so we're keeping it on our person, I assume.
So we get a symbol. Oh, this is Bob's analytical.
Wait a minute. Let's strap it to our body.
Okay.
I will strap it to my right thigh.
You can leave it with Trout if you want.
Leave
it with Trout.
It's a thing that looks like it kills zombies and vampires. Why
you're
going to
take it with you? No.
Okay. Wait. You're going to take it with you?
Yeah.
Nice.
Wow. There's like 3 sixes and 4 or 5.
We got rid of all your behind bolts. Let's get in battle.
I love it when we play it for like an hour and a half. We haven't rolled a die yet.
I rolled 2 dice.
You did. You rolled an investigation check. Congratulations.
Once.
We let the new guy do it.
I heard the running back.
Got a nice 5 there.
That
was good.
So like I said, the carnival starting up. Each of the Greek houses have stuff going on in the front yards. People are allowed to come in and out. It's kind of, check us out, have a party.
I'm in the mood for pie, guys.
Pie.
I ate a pie once.
Damn it. Mover Phi.
I don't understand. What do you mean?
Addison, you will.
All right.
When you become a man.
That's what I'm
okay. All right.
Wombo!
Oh, God, no.
Roxanne! Have you met Roxanne yet?
I have not.
Oh boy.
Roxanne, we have not seen Roxanne in quite some time.
Oh, no, wait. Oh, is this the pitcher?
She is definitely...
I remember distinctly 2 months ago a pitcher. I never want to see again.
Yep, that's Roxanne.
This would be Juan Lowe's appointed girlfriend.
Oh, no. I had trouble getting it out of my head. Oh, Jesus. Who's that guy in the bottom left?
That's your RA. You don't fool around much.
Oh, God.
And there would be Roxanne.
Oh, I can't erase this. It's Shrek's sister.
I almost had it gone.
It's Shrek's sister plus Lou Ferrigno. That's who that is.
That is awesome. If anybody's listening,
Wally's the Hulk. Oh, my God. It's like an Oompa Loompa on steroids.
I love how she's like... doing the kissy face.
She's all peace out, man.
The peace out look.
Yeah, but why are her fingers unusually small?
Maybe because she ate... No.
Her nose is bulbous.
Yeah.
So anyway, Roxanne has leached, wrapped her arm around
mom
nose, and she is all about... Thank you for zooming in.
Oh, my great. Wow. Oh, my God. Oh, I burped. Wow. I burped. It did it. It's back to the throat. It's burning. Oh, God. I apologize if you're watching Roxanne Stevenson.
That's not a real name.
I know. Thank God.
So she wraps her arm around Wallow, and she is yammering on and on and on about nothing.
Hey, Roxanne, have you met my friend Ford? I think he said he liked you.
Hey, Ford. Check out the chick. Ford, huh? Ford?
Edison looks like a deer in headlights.
She's not even interested in Ford. That's how bad Ford is.
Yeah. She's all about Wanlow right now. She's missed her little China man. I miss my little China man.
Aww,
oh, come on, cutie pie. She plants a big kiss on your cheek. It starts to melt.
Egg roll, baby, egg roll.
Duck and roll.
Trying to find somebody's. What's his name? What's her name there?
Who?
They're
not all on the page.
Was my girl?
Yeah.
My girl.
Missy Jordan? Missy Jordan is under. No, she's here.
So we're staring at a picture. Let's make it a nice picture that I want to stare at.
Is the Alabama?
Right here.
Alabama? Missy Jordan's top right. Top right. There she is.
Alabama Alpha Phi Sorority video is under fire for being too hot. The video is worse for women than Donald Trump. That's what it says.
There's Tony Hidalgo. I knew I had a picture of him. That was the guy who you got shirt. No.
Yeah, that's the guy I like to talk.
That was the guy who you were talking to about in the brewery.
He looks like Mr. Roper from Three's Company.
No.
And there's Johnny Moon's girlfriend, Missy Jordan.
Oh, I thought it was the girl who ended up getting room with, who was in that room with Flounder.
No.
She's still not bad.
Big car.
She's
not bad.
Yeah, I agree. Very
Jennifer Love Hewitt, no.
Yeah, she's just plain Jane.
Did you ever see Darmouse?
Anyway, we're going. Focus.
Hair's thinning.
So, you're tough.
Me?
Yeah.
So, Roxanne has got Juan Lowe in a death grip.
I married a pervert.
It's on recording.
Roxanne.
Married a pervert?
As you guys are approaching...
His wife did. Hey, perfect.
As you guys are approaching Alpha Phi and some of the brothers from...
Another month.
Beta Sigma recognize Juan Lowe from the in AR. Beside themselves, they're already in the bag. They're trying not to piss their pants laughing at it.
Did I get a curse at some point and I missed it?
Oh, Juan, I've missed you so much. Where have you been?
I've been doing homework.
We have slid 15 feet away from him.
Hey guys, wait up.
Toot off.
Just let it go, sacrifice. Hey, Wong Lo, your girlfriend's going to get really mad that this girl's hanging on you.
Wong Lo don't have a girlfriend.
Shedison, he's got two.
He doesn't have any girlfriend.
What do you mean? You have a girlfriend?
We took that trip to Mexico, and there was one of the girls on the bus who kind of saved her life, and One thing lead to another, and yeah, we kind of dated now.
That didn't happen.
Hey, I think Edison need a beer.
I need 20 feet away. Come on, Edison. I'm gonna take you to get a beer. Come on, Edison. Crunch.
You just watched a Voltron marathon yesterday night from like 7 until midnight. You were
Joe Dippy, let's get Edison a drink.
Why are you lying to me? Are you trying to make me jealous so I want you even more?
Oh, no.
I think we should get Edison a couple drinks.
What?
I think we should get Edison a couple drinks.
I think we should get Edison a club to the head. A club soda.
We should have given Edison a club to the head the day we met him, but it's a little late for that.
Hey, Roxanne, are you pledging to any of the sororities?
Not this one, because you're actually at Alpha Phi at this point.
Oh.
But there was an Omega something down the street I was looking at.
Omega Mu?
That was it, yes.
My C, said the black man to his FY.
5 page. Come on. The 5-6-sigma are...
Well, you know what? We're pledging for Beta Sigma. We can't talk to you right now. We're in very strict
orders.
Beta
Sigma, those guys are smuts.
I realize that. That's why we can't talk to you.
We don't have any strict orders.
But they take architecture majors, so I mean, I'm an architect major. So you know. So I'll go to Russia. And yeah, if you're Russian,
any
move, you know, kind of don't work.
Are you trying to tell us like Romeo and Juliet, star-crossed lovers who can't be together because of their they're fraternities and sororities?
Listen.
Yes, and I think Juliet killed herself first, yes?
Wong Lo, is the transgender operation going well for you? Have you gotten rid of the crabs yet? Is the drip stopped?
Those hormones just start to kick in soon.
Do you like seafood? Are the crabs going well? Wong Lo, how are you doing? Has the AIDS gotten cured yet?
Okay, Juan. I'll tell you, because we both have to keep up appearances.
So good.
So I'm gonna get over here. I'm gonna head back down to the other station, but I'll catch up with you later tonight. Back at the dorm. All
right, sounds good. You know where to find me.
Where will you meet her? At 2 o'clock. Back meet by
dorm.
The flagpole.
Yes.
No, back at the dorm. I know where he lives.
Oh, crank.
Cheer up, buddy.
Somebody get me a drink on to me.
So she wanders off. A couple of the brothers from Beta Sigma come over. They can't keep it straight. They're trying to keep the beer in their mouth and they're trying to dispute on you, laughing at you.
Is that your girlfriend?
Fuck you guys.
No accent.
No. I was trying to win the accent.
Joe Tiffy, what's the story with this guy and that thing? Joe Tiffy,
you're on mute.
Some of the brothers are done mocking.
Sorry, guys, I was on mute.
some of the guys are mocking Juan Lo about Roxanne. And they're asking you.
I don't know why they're mocking Juan Lo. I mean, she's right up his alley. Actually, she is the alley.
She's the alley, the block,
the
city.
The ball. Because, you know, that's not how many chances to get in.
Juan Lo, have you ever been bowling?
Yeah.
There you go. That's Roxanne. Just bend her over and bowl.
I don't think that's very nice, Joe Dippy.
Edison, since when has nice got anything to do with me in the conversation?
Yeah, you make a good point there, Edison.
Well, yeah, I guess that is a good point.
I did bring you over to the Beta House and got you totally hooked up with them guys about their computer science homework. You were like a pig rolling around in shit.
That was a lot of fun, I have to say. You're right about that.
But okay. It was enough fun that you told me you'd be back next Tuesday.
That's true.
Incidentally, arriving on Edison's email earlier in the day, I forgot to mention, was the physics final from last year.
Oh, really? Also, they just get... Oh my god, the physics file's on my phone. Delete!
Edison.
Delete!
Whoa, 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 whoa! Slow your roll, Edison! forward that to me, and I'll delete that for you.
That's wrong. You get in so much trouble. That's the worst kind of life.
It was the last year's final. There's nothing wrong with that.
I'm going to have to format my phone. Oh, my God. Quickly format everything.
I got to throw my phone out. I got to change my number.
I got to scratch my
eyes. Are you Tom Brady? Yeah. Warren comes up to you guys, rescues you from the mocking of the other boys.
Thank the Lord.
Says, I need a really horrible name for him.
Einstein.
I was thinking Einstein. Hey, Doc.
Edison looks around for another guy. I think he's talking to you, Edison.
No, my name's Edison.
Hey, Doc Brown.
That's a horrible name.
Doc Brown, did you get that email from my friend?
Oh, yeah.
Thank you for your
it
help.
Right away. You gotta be careful. You'll get in trouble.
All right, that was last year's final. There's nothing wrong with that.
No.
Nowhere on there does that say you can't do anything with it.
I think I'm going to have to double-check the code of conduct, because I don't think that's right.
Well, anyway, that was my friend. My friends were thanking.
Oh. Also, question number 11 was incorrect. The answer forgot the decimal. It should be 11.3.
Yeah, that's why there's an X on it.
Oh.
6 figures.
Anyway, can you guys, I get you guys a drink. Why don't you come on over here?
I use a vest of drink, please, if you don't mind.
All right.
I'll take that tall drink of water in the corner.
You mean Bob?
I think her name is Sally.
No, there's a water jug in the corner right over there.
It's got a name on it, Sally. I think that's what he's talking about.
Missy points out to the gentleman, look, there she goes. And you see, you recognize Bonnie. You watch her.
I didn't have
a chance to get a picture for her.
So she's in
the house. It wasn't tough to find one picture.
That we've gone from if there's no name, it's, you know, everybody has a name now. Now it's a picture. So if there's no picture,
I'm gonna run up to Bonnie.
You see her across the way. She's walking into the place.
Damn.
So, okay, Candace Cameron, there. There's your picture.
Do we notice that?
She was Cameron or Candace before, right?
Candace Cameron from Full House as a teenager.
Oh. She doesn't look a whole lot different now.
A little bit pudgy, kind of curly hair.
Yeah. Not attractive, but not Roxanne.
She's kind of cute now, isn't she?
I'm Dancing with the Stars, because, you know,
oh.
I have a wife and two daughters.
The only thing you get, the cuter they look.
So,
all right, see her go by.
So you see, she points out her going inside.
Do we know where about does she go?
She goes in the front door.
Oh, she's going in. Okay, we're outside. Gotcha.
Yeah, you're between, you're on the street, but the car is going, the car. The,
gotcha.
And she, you see her walk in.
All right.
Hey, guys, if we go through the super cat house and walk around the back and get in the back door.
You want to go through the back door? Huh? You stinky
monkey. We should be able to walk the front door here.
God can't see that.
There's a loophole there, but we're not going to talk about it.
It's called the loophole.
We didn't say the loophole.
All right, so, what's the plan?
We're going to walk in the front door. That's what
we're going to say, is there more alcohol liquor inside?
All the houses are open house right now.
Let's bring this party inside.
All right.
Let's get this party started.
Right now.
Joe, you leading the way, Joe?
Absolutely.
Can we do this in a conga line? Can we do this like holding hips, going?
Not if you want to talk to these girls and have a shot.
Yeah, that'd be so cool. In my mind, at least.
You know, in about 3 more hours, you're really loaded, maybe.
You do that and you put a lampshade on your head.
Then it'll actually be cool at that point.
That's right. Yeah, this is
all right. So Joe, lead the way. Tell us.
My Joe, conga line.
Heading in.
That's what you said.
All right, so
I went down there.
I pulled up the map here.
That's what you said. That's good. No, that's boring.
Hey, ladies.
You walk into the entry foyer.
We're all trying to keep up.
Or whatever it is. And there's a fair number. You don't see Bonnie. You know, it took you a couple minutes to get over there.
I tell him, you guys have a great
backyard. Missy Jordan won't go in with you. She's afraid to go in.
Have you seen, I have to say, it is really, truly marvelous. Have you seen Warren's death? It is huge. I have to say, I've never seen anything like it before. I mean, all of us are just envious of it. It's just beautiful.
Well, I'm more concerned about Alpha Phi's hedges. They are trimmed. Oh, you know what I'm talking about.
I thought the landscape was pretty good.
It is groomed.
Oh.
Well manicured.
Yeah.
Oh,
So wait, so just out of character a little bit. So Missy won't go in because of Bonnie?
Missy won't go in because when she tried to follow Bonnie in once before, there was an incident and she's afraid.
With Bonnie?
She tried to go in, no, with the girls in the house.
So the girls in the house gave her
yes.
something,
Brief.
Not just Bonnie.
The girls in the house gave her a hard time.
Yes, the girls in the house
frightened her away.
There
checking on Bonnie. So,
the girls
okay.
in the house gave her the clap.
Oh, jeez. Okay, so it's not just Bonnie then. Okay, all right.
Well, hi there, boys. I'm Susie Grant. I'm the pledge master for this house.
Well, yes, you are. Doesn't make any sense.
What can I do for you? Do you have anyone here you know?
Well, I know her. I know Susie McDougal, Lori, Johnny Cocktail Stone.
Johnny Cocktail Stone.
Marie Cocktail Toast Stone. There you go.
I'm
looking for Fletch.
Fletch? So I don't know. We don't have a Fletch here. We have a Fletcher. No, we don't.
We're actually Fletcher for Beta Sigma.
Really?
We are, and
I don't see the. You don't have the telltale signs though.
Joe Dippy was. He's got them.
Okay. Oh, hi. Ooh. Joe Dippy has a little pin, by the way, that you guys didn't recognize.
He's
got a little kid.
Which is he has a pledge pin.
A pledge pin.
Thanks, Dippy.
On your uniform.
Dippy.
So, Joe, are you going to talk to Susie? So what are you guys doing here? What can I do for you? You want to see the house?
We'd love to.
We'd like to see more than the house.
All right, well, Martha here is going to take you around because sure. My job is to greet everybody. So
you're doing a great job, huh?
Martha.
Do we get a sticker with a smiley face? Like Walmart?
No, but after you take a drink of the three drinks here, give me your drink passport and we'll stamp it. So you get to be around the campus party.
Oh, hell yeah.
Can you show us one more time about
this
how to stamp
is
it?
Very international.
Oh, yeah. It's party. It's a party.
Oh, and you have only begun to learn to fight for your life.
So Martha Curry comes over. She looks exactly like Marsha Breen.
All right. She's all right. Long hair, short hair.
Older Marsha. Long hair.
Ooh. All right. Now we're talking.
Marsha.
No, the real Marsha.
I didn't have any problem with that either.
The real Marsha.
Not the okay.
Not the fakey. So she starts taking you around the house, and she takes you through the formal living room. You know, somebody's playing gently on the piano.
What?
Which is kind of weird.
Yeah. It's awesome. Your curtains match your carpet.
Yeah, well, that's because boys don't live here.
That's amazing.
You guys have carpets.
Somebody said they have carpets. It's not fair.
And the carpet doesn't cut your feet when you walk on it.
It's just nice. I missed that one.
So, here's one of our study lounges. And, it's more of a party lounge. There's not much going on in this area of the house. It's just kind of the formal section. Because there's nothing.
The
party's in the back.
Plastic on the couch.
You hear a lot of commotion from the
just
back.
Just like my hair.
Amen. Party's in the back, guys.
Business in the front, party in the back.
Here's the restrooms. If you scroll up a little bit, Adam, you can see there's a restroom.
That's where all the girls are in line.
We got another bathroom.
No, because they have their own bathroom. This is for visitors.
Four?
Yeah.
So,
mm-hmm.
Do you ever get worried that we're just a bunch of walking cliches?
Never crossed my mind.
No, me neither.
I don't get it. Tell you what?
No.
You want a bed, Red?
Yep.
And I go on with that. 3:30. As long as I'm
6:30.
You insane?
I've been getting up at 4:30 to work out for the tough part.
Wow.
So yes.
Yeah. Thank God I said no to that.
Yeah, right.
Christ.
I got you a discount. You can get it for only $100 instead of $120 next year.
Well, you know what I've been doing though? I've been carb loading for the past 6 years.
I've been not tough mind.
I am ready for next year.
What was it? I'm doing the prayer diet, the miracle diet. What was it? I just eat whatever I want and pray something good is going to happen. All right, so you got that.
That was pretty much my mode.
You got a men's room and a women's room there. You can see near the grand, to the left of the grand staircase. There's a small male room. And you walk past. Once you leave the staircase down, you'll note that the door has a keypad lock on it.
Good night, Amy.
Dead bolted from the top side.
There's a keypad lock on it.
A keypad lock.
Yes.
So would that be lockpicking or electronics or?
Is it is like a standard one?
It's a nine digits with star on the top.
Is there a kitchen?
We'll get there. She's giving you the tour.
Excellent. Hey.
Notice check just to see if Edison notices if any of the keypads look a little more worn than others.
Go ahead.
I'm going to do a notice just because I'm a expert in noticing.
Nosing?
Not that. Five.
You are too distracted by Martha's fantastic figure to notice anything other than Martha's fantastic
that
figure.
That is journalism.
Martha.
Attention
to details.
To help Edison out, I'm going to do a notice in case he didn't notice anything on those digits. Because Edison doesn't really know about how to get the digits.
So Edison, it looks fairly new. You know, it's only been there a few years, and they may not use it a lot, so
okay.
It's hard to tell that it doesn't look like there's any, not from your quick pass by.
Sure, sure.
No.
There's not four numbers whose numbers are worn down.
Yeah.
I take out my black light and look for the oil and fingerprints.
What is
the
password?
So
what?
Just punch a four-digit code.
Two.
Yeah.
Three.
Roll like six.
All right, come on, guys.
All right, let's
go. Guys, that's just the basement. There's nothing worth going through
down
there.
Hey, can we check out the kitchen? I'm just
Edison,
curious.
I think you can try the combination 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay, sure. So
1, 2, 3, 4,
there's,
5.
There's a couple of
like an idiot.
There's handicapped accessible bedrooms down here. So she doesn't show you those. She just kind of waves them over. She takes you through the big dining area. We have a lot of room here. We feed. Sometimes we feed the homeless. We bring in people who are underprivileged, so we'll feed them. We'll offer special things to help them out.
Are we in the kitchen?
And she takes you all the way across the way to the kitchen on the right.
Wow, what a lovely dining area.
You can see the big deck off the back where your boners were all rousing around.
Wow, that must seat about 112 people. That's amazing.
While these guys are talking, I'm going to look to see if I can find flour or some sort of powder.
It's a frat party.
I'm getting there.
You can find all kinds of powder.
I'm going to find flour.
Several different varieties of powder.
I'm going to find some flour, a Ziploc bag, and put some in a Ziploc bag.
What are you... You're going to go through the kitchen?
I distract her.
Okay. Now, no, I'm going to tell her.
No,
gonna,
there's women coming and going. I mean, there's 40. You know, there's,
I'm going to tell her this is part of Beta Sigma's rush. I have to find certain things for this whole rush thing, and flowers, one of them, steal it from, you know, quote unquote, steal it from the girls. So I just need a little Ziploc and some flour.
Sure, here
it's
you go.
It's crazy, but.
Here's our first drink of the night.
It's a panties.
It's yeah.
I just was in for the flour. Great idea.
Women's underwear.
So there's a serving line there, between the last table.
That's for Melissa later. He's gonna roll her around in it and see if he can find the wet spot.
I'll drink.
So there's a serving line here, guys, where they're serving out of test tubes, shots of some sort of green liquor or green drink.
Ooh, liquor.
Absinthe.
Hardly know.
And you'll notice there's a stack of little books that say drink passport on them.
Books.
Oh. I'll take a drink passport book. I'll take a drink.
Is there anybody who's serving the test tube shots?
Yes. There's three girls there making it.
I mean, how they really serve test tube shots.
Out of the belly buttons or
no?
Out
of the shot glass.
Out of the
shot glass.
Did I?
She did.
We clicked off.
Oh, then you dropped the. Oh, jeez! It's all your fault, Jeff.
Now, Mikey can still hear us because it goes through Josh's bad ass.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah. Right. You're fine. I saw Adam drop off too, so.
And it's a Joan boy.
And
who else wants to get their drink stamped? Who wants to get a drink and get a stamp?
Yeah, what's up?
Who doesn't want to get a drink?
I happen to collect stamps. I think this is great. Sure.
All right,
you have to drink
what's in the test tube, and then we stamp your stamp. We're both
drinking.
Stamps plus test tubes. Count me in. This sounds great. What is this, like Kool-Aid?
Yeah, sure.
High C.
Yeah, sure. Here you go.
This is like Gatorade, right?
Cool. Yeah, here you go. Drink it.
Okay.
It's sort of like Kool-Aid.
Oh, it's a love story of the Gatorade.
151.
This Gatorade's gone bad.
So she stamps everybody's book. What about you?
You know what? I'm doing a review in a paper. I can't do that right now. But guess what? I'm going to hit the keg stands.
You're not doing a review of the paper.
Are you
Edison?
Yeah.
Did you like that drink?
I love that drink. That
What's 42 good. Times pi?
It's 42.
Anyway, pi. Yes?
Hang on one more minute.
I'm a little disappointed.
Don't you be
you
disappointed.
If you want to write about this, you got to experience for what it is.
Where's your keg stand? Because that's where I'm headed next.
We don't do keg stands here.
What kind of party is this?
It's a girls' party.
Sorority party.
142-ish, Bob?
I'm gonna do a shot later for you. Go ahead, guys. Chug, 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 chug.
No, it's not a chug. It's a tall test.
I know, but I'm trying to get everybody distracted.
So
chug.
I'm gonna go 137.
Oh, dear God.
No, it's not that high.
What?
Yes, it is.
All of you. Oh, my God.
42 times pi? Oh, 123... Anyway.
Yes, but I shut Edison up for at least a little while.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. So, Martha takes another shot. It's obvious she's had a fair share of them tonight.
Woohoo! Shh. I give her some beef.
Let's see. Does she whoop?
Nothing.
She walks you through the rest of the.
No beads. Nothing.
She takes you into the front hall.
So I heard this is like a new building, right?
Yeah.
You guys
had
some problems.
Like, years.
Burnt down.
Yeah.
But everybody was okay, like there was only...
Nobody died.
But
I know,
looked up.
It's East Texas University, nobody died at something. We are truly blessed.
Amen.
People were playing darts whizzing by people's heads.
We are truly blessed.
Just weird shit. Just hot iron falls, missing somebody's face.
Why does anybody live here?
All right, so did you guys want to go upstairs and see the rest of the place and get their last two stamps?
Yes.
Yes, bedrooms?
If you're not drinking, I can't take you up there.
All right, I'll do a shot of the test tube.
All right.
Put it in the mouth. Wait, you spit it out. Holy shit, that's so hot.
Hello, one of the ones upstairs.
You're sissier than some of the girls we have upstairs. Look at the Doc Brown over there next to you today.
I know, but listen, I'm wearing women's panties because Beta Sigma told me I got to wear women's panties, and they are riding up my crotch.
You're wearing women's panties right now?
Edison.
Tell a lie. Tell me where women's underwear. I'll drink his.
There you go.
Alright, then you can sign his passport for me.
Well, why don't you have your own a second passport book?
Alright, that sounds great.
It's so freaking awesome, dude.
Alright, the second one.
That was really good.
So you have two stamp books.
I got two stamp books.
You gotta give one to Chris.
I have a double baby.
Hey, this is the greatest thing ever. Edison.
What?
Can I have a stamp book?
No, it's mine.
Edison.
No.
Naked women, Edison.
What? Oh, here.
Thank you.
All right, so she brings you up the stairs here. You see, there's a. She takes you out to the front. She brings you up the grand stairs.
They do look grand, by the way.
Those are great stairs.
And Edison, they're not great. They're grand.
Sure, but I mean, there's women all over. It's not like you can watch.
Oh, no, I mean, we get to watch her go upstairs first.
You guys are fighting over who gets to follow her up the stairs.
Hey, Four, if two stairs have a baby, and then that baby has a baby, then the first set of stairs, they're grand stairs.
It would be like a stepping stool.
Yeah. Grand
to get divorced.
They're grandparent grand stairs.
That'd be correct, Edison.
You got pretty
That's
eyes,
weird.
For.
That's weird.
It took the words out my mouth.
The sun, if you scroll out a little
critic?
Bit, you can't get to the sun deck. I don't laugh, but I'm going through a better.
This was my rifle.
Alright, so she takes you around and she points out some of the rooms.
Have you seen his deck?
Yeah, the sun deck is only out on the back
floor. No, there's
not
on the left.
Yeah, but that's not doing great.
Oh,
very big.
So she takes you around, she points out some of the cleaner rooms. There are girls in various stages of dress who really don't seem to care.
But I care.
That you're seeing.
Forge.
Yes.
They're not wearing all their clothes. Oh.
Yes, Edison. I think you should get your camera out.
Also, I can't feel my ear.
You don't have any ears, Edison.
How much toes? They all tingly.
This is all off two drinks.
What?
Oh,
he weighs
like
98 pounds.
He's got a
Bob in real life.
What is it? A vigor of 4. Yeah, a D4 vigor. Yeah, that's about right.
She takes you around to that front lounge there, where the next round of drinks are.
Oh, and there's a balcony off looking over the front yard.
Yeah, they won't let you have the balcony.
Oh.
That's actually pretty smart.
Yeah, there's been issues.
It's fantastic. Is
there,
that
in that
fantastic.
Front lounge, there's two drinks. In the front lounge, Jeff, there are two drinks.
Does anybody else notice that the lounge looks like it's two boobs? The doors?
Actually, I was thinking
the double doors.
I'm an ass master.
Hey, there it is.
So there's two drinks. One is a red. It looks like it's probably a sangria type drink.
Mm-hmm. Edison,
yeah, no, then you're asking. I drink it.
Edison, here's my pass.
Oh, I'm honored to hold this vital, important document for you, Thor.
Edison, it's time to drink.
Oh.
This is a Kool-Aid type drink.
Oh yeah. Oh.
It's red. A little darker red than Kool-Aid, but it's like a sweet sangria.
Thor, get away from the wall.
This is all
get away
again.
From the wall, Thor.
Oh, yeah.
He's
so over here, over here we have a drink, and instead of a drink, our third item is actually some Jell-O we made.
Hey,
Thor,
there's always room for Jell-O.
I like Jell-O.
If
we have watermelon and cherry and strawberry. You only have to try one, though, to get your stamp.
I'll do strawberry, please.
You sure?
Try cherry as well.
No, wait, cherry.
And strawberry.
No, wait, watermelon.
Straw cherry.
No, go back to strawberry.
One girl, I'm assuming Joe Diffie's indulging as well.
Joe's actually trying to wander off into some girl's room.
Well, actually, the girl is giving out the Jell-O shots. Instead of stamps your book. Then rubs a stamp really kind of softly against
Whoa,
your hand.
Joe Dippy.
Yeah, that happened to me at Tough Mudder.
No, didn't. Some of the girls there, I could have. Anyway. So she gives you the little eye, Joe Dippy. She's not a bad little
Roger
thing.
Roger that.
She's not a bad little thing.
Are you picking up what I'm putting
she
down?
Says, she says, I get off shift at 11.
What time do you usually get off?
I will meet you back here at 10:50.
Sounds like a plan.
They work in shifts here?
Huh. Well, you don't expect me to stand here all night and not have any fun myself, do you?
Do you have a union? Because you shouldn't really get, you know...
No, we're a volunteer organization.
Oh, that's...
Here, why don't you have the red drink down?
All right.
Still
yes.
Stuck.
I'm having a great time, guys. This is so fun. We should do this all the time.
I wish we didn't have to investigate these
for their crazy... Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus, there was a fire. I didn't have my shoes or nothing.
Why don't we do this every night? This is great.
Dippy does.
Yeah, Dippy does. That's true.
Oh, Dippy.
So
pretty much a regular occurrence in my world.
Out of character?
Out of character.
Yeah, actually, we are. We healed our 100th patient 2 or 3 weeks ago.
Hey, when you heal your 100th patient, does like a confetti parade of band-aids fall from the ceiling tiles?
No, that's stupid. Just balloons.
Oh, it's a balloons fall from the ceiling?
That's a
shitty balloon.
Go ahead,
pass.
Yeah, girls' panties.
Wait, what?
No, actually, so we healed a bunch of the patient. I mean, our heal rate's at 92%.
Wow.
Do you guys have specialty, or is it just like
just wound care?
Emergency?
Any kind of wound, chronic wound.
Okay.
Venous, diabetic, depression.
All right, so
trauma.
Joe Diffie's made a friend. Her name is Veronica.
Veronica.
And does she have a friend, Betty?
Oh, yeah. That could not be more fitting.
Well, Mikey?
Veronica Vaughn.
I said that name could not be more fitting. Someday I'll fill you in about Veronica.
I know personal.
All right. So,
no, you don't.
So you notice that your books all have another dozen or 15 pages, different sororities and fraternities on them where you have to go get a drink and get it stamped.
You can just imagine
doing that, right? Yeah. So, Beta Sigma has two stamps in it from their house, being a slightly smaller house.
We look around as much as we can without being obnoxious and obvious.
Okay.
Is Diffy getting any feelings up in this area with the rooms?
Diffy's thinking he's going to be feeling something.
Is he getting any feelings above the belt?
Joe's definitely getting a lot of feelings, but... It's not what you're thinking.
Hooked on a feeling.
It's more than a feeling.
We were watching Guardians of the Galaxy earlier. Yeah. So, Anyway.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah.
So, yeah, I mean, everything seems pretty normal. But for the most part, the doors are all open. The rooms are fairly clean and made.
We got to get in that basement, boys. Let's go back down to the... I whispered to the guys here. Let's go back to that keypad. I got a little idea.
Sure. So the tour's over. Do you need me to show you out, or...
Thank you very much. What's your name again, Veronica?
No, I'm Marcia.
Marcia, can I find my way in?
You have a you have a lovely home.
Edison, stop. Okay, home.
Okay, guys, I just have one statement. If he throws up, you're cleaning it up.
Don't you worry about that. We'll hold his hair.
He's got iron stomach.
Ford's not going to throw up.
If he falls down the stairs and breaks his neck, we don't want to know about it.
Do you have a baggie?
We'll just bury him out of the woods. No worries.
I've done that.
We won't throw up in your basement. Edison, shut up.
You guys are the best out of all the places that I've been ever in my life. You're better than Disneyland. You're better than Legoland. You're better than Hershey Place.
Air and Space Museum.
The Space Museum. the Boston Science Museum, of course.
You know, hey, there's some chips and stuff downstairs in the dining area. You might want to get him some snacks.
Madison, we're going to get
Marcia. I'm sorry. He's,
it's always fun to watch a lightweight in action.
I like chips.
That was a great show.
Eric Estrada.
Where did they store your chips?
Eric Estrada driving down the highway.
All right, so we're gonna make our way back downstairs to the door.
We're gonna make our way down to the dining area.
Plenty of chippies and snackies there.
Oh, nice. Anything good? Like wings? Because I like some wings.
No, it's useless carbs.
Where's the door down, Joshua?
Was that?
Where's the door down?
Yeah, we don't want useless protein.
Just
so there's a locked door over here.
All right, I'm gonna go back to the keypad.
All right, there's people in the lounge.
There's people wandering about all over the place.
All right, so
it's really not a good time.
No. All right.
What if we do the double? We have five guys.
Yep.
If we do two people blocking the top hallway, two people blocking the bottom hallway.
Distraction time.
One person in the middle. I don't know is it going to be obvious? Or are we going to be able to block?
Edison, can you give me a
sobriety check?
Yeah, whatever. What would that be?
Edison, can you give me a topless run through the party screaming check?
Pantsless check.
All right.
Vigor is D4. Oh no, did I level that up by one last time? I leveled it up by one. I'm at D6 now, so I went from 90.
Oh, you're not as strong as you thought you were.
That's right. You did say you learned a bit.
Yeah, that's right. I forgot. Five.
So just as Edison is about to do the pants off dance off.
Man.
on one of the tables. He stops and has a brief moment of clarity. Is this really a smart thing to do?
Smart. Super smart. Smartest thing you ever did.
We do that about
Edison.
Guys,
we are a team. And in being a team, you need to take this for the team.
Who's fonder when you need
it?
Discovery
Channel.
Travel just said, hi, how are you?
Maybe we can come back.
There's no time like the present. Take your pants off and don't run.
Don't forget that Mikey has been invited back for later.
Joe Dick, I can get in there.
What
quiet.
Time is it now?
Maybe it's 10 o'clock.
Alright, we got it, guys. We got an hour. Let's go outside.
I'm not wearing any underwear.
Let's go fill up our passwords.
Are there other looser fraternities?
I think we'll get a little bit stealthier the more passports we get. The more stairs we get. So let's go next door.
You go to Beta Sigma where they pseudo know you.
Let's go to a place that they don't know us where we can get
trash
ladies.
Yeah.
Johnny Mood, you should get
where you can get ladies.
A degree in physics because you are a genius. All right.
Is anybody carrying? Anybody got their weapon right now?
No.
I got my weapons on me all the time.
I got my weapon.
Well, look, gun one, gun two.
Loaded.
Firepower.
I'm gonna shoot blanks.
On the other side of Alpha Phi. On the other side of Alpha Phi is
Johnny, your age.
Theta Gamma.
Oh, Theta Gamma.
Theta Gamma. It's the gay fraternity. But you gotta go in there to get your drinks.
Hey, next to them.
Guys, let's go. There's drinks in here.
Edison rushes through the door.
Fortunately for you, there's only one drink station. It's right inside the door. It's a froofy chick. It's Sex on the Beach.
Think about how the girls serve the shots in the test tubes.
But disguise.
Jeff Dean.
That sounds more like a rugby drink.
So they're having Sex on the Beach shots.
Guys, can I have one of those shots? Can I have Sex on the Beach with you? This is great.
Yes.
All right. So they give you your shot.
Guys, let's all have Sex on the Beach.
Guy stamps it, writes his name, his number.
Guys, everybody together at once.
Get number.
Let's all have Sex on the Beach together.
Yay.
No.
So, all right. So who drinks there?
Ethan, I'm a completionist.
I am still not drinking.
Joe, are you having sex? Are you drinking Sex on the Beach at the gay frat house?
Oh yeah, I gotta get my check. I gotta get my stamp on my book. So yeah.
All right. So that's drink number four. Yes, four. You're all starting to feel a little bit.
Joe's a professional
drinker. He's got a hollow leg.
Joe Dippy's like, what?
He's Jeff.
Bring the
There's some games that are set up now. You know, knock the bottles off. The money's all supposed to get raised and go to get donated to something.
Is there anybody doing lawn darts? I totally want to play lawn darts.
No, but you see Roxanne off in a distance.
I walked the other way.
And she only looks like a negative five.
Remember, she's a 2 at 10, a 10 at 2.
She's far from good and far from far.
Yeah, good material, brother. That's good material.
So,
thank you. I had to think about that one. I'm sorry.
I like that one.
She's good from far, but far from good.
Yeah. Yeah.
She's a 2 at 10.
All right, so.
Do you remember that bag right there on the top?
Yes.
All right, so what's next?
You try.
No, I'm good.
There's still another half dozen frat houses. There's more drinks. There's games. The money does go to charity.
All right, let's not give any money away. Let's have drinks.
All right, so you make it to the. You're not even drinking.
I know. But I'm getting these guys drunk because I love watching drunk people.
Joe Diffie. You're going to lead the way around the different
frat houses.
Joe
Diffie.
Joe Diffie's made some rounds here.
What was that?
I'm good. You going to take you guys around for some introductions and beverages?
You broke up again. What was that?
I was going to say, you had your drink at the gay frat house, so you're going to take the guys to the rest of the houses. Since you seem to know
them well. I'll keep bringing them around till about enough time to get me back about 10 minutes to 11 for Veronica.
All right, so it is. You guys are all hammered. Edison is going to die.
So we
blend
right in, guys.
We're not hammered.
Guys,
we passed up a couple drinks.
We're faking it though.
Make it freaking awesome. I was 13 years old. It was question number 14. I put C, but I meant to put B. I got a 94. That's an A minus. It was an A minus. I'll never forgive myself. A minus.
What's your plan? I assume you've devised something at this point. I mean, it's starting to wind.
We're in college and there's free drinks. We didn't plan shit.
The official event ends at 12. So you expect the party to be kind of slowed down by 12:30, 1 o'clock. A lot of passing out.
I have an idea. If Joe Diffie, he could go have a sleepover, and then after they watch a TV show, he comes downstairs and lets us in, and then we go into the basement. And then we have nachos. Because nachos are good.
But you know what? There's a problem with that.
What?
You can't have the nachos.
Why?
Because they're nachos!
Nacho races the laughter.
That is giggling on the floor, curling up the ball laughter.
Yeah. Edison is incapacitated for 1d4 rounds. Let's see, that would be...
Help you get more loaded?
Two rounds. Right. Nice.
Thank you. Not that you need it, but...
I know, right?
All right, so Joe Diffie makes his move. What are you guys doing? Are you hanging out? Sigma? They made a Sigma? Are you going to hang out in the street? What are you going to do?
Huh?
We're
going to be a... Well, tell us, because he's asking us what we're doing.
How do you get to the basement?
That's really nice.
Probably from the door on the outside, and I wonder if there's a bulkhead on the outside.
There's stairs there, right? Go down.
Yeah.
What about the handicapped people who maybe...
The lift?
The lift.
Does the lift...
That alarm system probably came after they built the... They rebuilt the building.
Yeah.
So that there's two lifts.
Uh-huh.
One of them might go down to the basement.
There's two lifts?
I got a little flower, right?
Hello, you know architecture. Does that make sense? You think that's true?
It could be. I mean, you don't need two lifts to go all the way upstairs. There's one. If memory serves correctly, there's one lift by the grand staircase, and then there's a back staircase up. That one looked like it went upstairs, but then there was a lift off by the dining room that didn't look like it went upstairs at all. Probably went down to the basement. So we could try that too. Just go around the door, go use the lift.
The problem is that could also be locked. Where you need a key or you need a touch pad.
You know, I just thought of another problem too. The house has no vinyl siding. That means somebody's going to have to paint it every 7 years. That's terrible. The wood, the tree.
Actually, it's brick though.
Oh, it's
brick? It's made out of brick.
I was going to say, it's East Texas. It's like every 20
years. Oh, there's no problem then. Never mind. Phew.
But if it's not insulated properly, it's going to cost a fortune.
Now, guys, I did see in a movie once, if you take powder and you blow it on the keypad, the oil residual from the fingers would light up on the keypad, and we could go through a series of numbers.
That's really smart.
It's worth a try.
Edison, if there's four digits,
yeah,
and four numbers come up, how many possibilities is that?
4 to the 4th power. That's approximately...
1,000 possibility. 10,000 possibility?
Yes, but we're going to do the most logical. A birthday.
What was the date of the fire?
That's, I'm sure, something I want to remember.
Now you were on it.
Oh, yeah!
December 7th, 2009.
120709?
No.
Well, you're really smart. All of you guys are really smart.
You're assuming it's a 4-digit code.
I love you, guys.
I just need 10 digits. 10-digit.
All right, so Joe Diffie goes in.
Wait,
disappears.
Man. Oh, Joe Diffie. Get your Diffie.
You
down.
Can go in, but he's leaving you.
We're in.
Yeah, we're in.
All right,
Why are we going in?
Edison, chip table, make it.
So Veronica is
dip your chips.
Veronica is surprised and happy to see Joe, and they quickly adjourn to Veronica's room, where the door closes.
Wait a minute. We don't need to know where we are. Let's get details. Come on, buddy.
All right, we go down to the main dining room.
Main floor. Okay.
Yeah, we try and look at this lift by the accessible bedrooms. Surreptitiously.
Medicine is not
nice.
Really.
Doors. December, huh?
I know. Surreptitious
at this point.
Well, no, you're the distraction.
Me and Edison are whooping it up, whooping,
whoop,
like serotonin.
We can push a little bit and throw one of our passports into the elevator. I'm gonna go get it. We'll turn
it. Is
and
it
see
open?
What the controls are.
Okay, so you through dumb luck. The door opens, you can see it, you look inside, and there's a key to go to the basement.
Regular old key, huh?
Markburger?
The doors, is it, can you be concealed whilst you're fiddling with the key?
Yes.
The gate won't close unless you press the button.
Edison emerges from around the corner.
Markburger?
Guys,
yeah.
I discovered something. They've got Marciano cherries in the refrigerator. An entire jar.
You know what would be great? If you took your pants off while eating Maruchan Shashan cherry.
So four girls come over. They aren't the most attractive girls.
It's okay.
Well, it's late in the night.
It's late in the night.
So the tens are
they invite there, you, they invite you to come over to the table to help finish what's left of the green drinks.
Are they drinking the green drinks?
Oh, yeah.
Are there cards?
Their tongue matches your headband right now.
If there's cards, I know there's a game, poker. Play.
But they insist that Chris join, that Forrest are enjoying as well.
Okay. Let's join.
By the way, listeners, you heard that right.
Bladder.
Jeff is wearing a headband.
We did complete a tough mudder the other day. Jeff is wearing his green two-time headband.
Did you do it two times?
That's his second tough
mudder. Yeah, it was the second tough mudder, dude.
Oh. There was a group that ran past us doing a second time like that.
Really? So you went through it once and did it again?
Not us, but another group did.
They were doing less. So.
Was it a 12 mile?
9.5, 10?
My Christ. I dreamt I did that. I was tired.
What?
That tough mudder took 9 miles. Man, so
that was
tired.
A short one, too. Usually more like 12.
Well, yeah, we were lucky. At least you guys weren't on a mountain.
Yes.
Christ, I went for a 4-mile walk today doing geocaching. I had a heart attack. A little bit. All right, so yeah, we're gonna play strip poker. I'm gonna excuse myself because I ate some bad clam dip. By the way,
just get them drunk or they're gonna pass out soon. They're loaded. I mean, they're borderline.
Premium loaded.
What year are they?
What's their major?
What do they look like? What's their age? Birthdays.
So,
what?
They're three sheets to the wind, and then.
All right, grab two drinks. I give one to one girl. Like, cheers. They gave it to the other girl.
And they both drink down.
I grab two more.
What are we all, Bill Cosby? Come on, guys.
The amount of traffic in the hall in the main hall is definitely slowing down.
What's the Godzilla bullet pop?
You can.
Rudy.
You can see some of the girls having been bothered to go upstairs. You know, like the handicap accessible room. There was nobody sleeping. Nobody living there. There's like two girls passed out in there. There's three girls passed out at the table near you, face down, in the clam dip.
Hey! I see what you did there.
I think one of these has a key.
I'm going to go ahead and search them.
I need everybody who's drinking to give me a vigor check at -2.
Vigor -2.
I've been trying not to drink.
I haven't.
So you can have -1.
I had a drink.
You're -1.
Trying to. Edison gets a 3. He fails.
Edison now has a permanent -1 for the remainder of the evening.
Okay. I don't remember which of my
good days. -1?
4.
Okay, so you make it.
3.
You're a lightweight.
I am.
-1 for Chris on all rolls for the rest of the evening.
Seriously? Do I want to go Edison's strength? Like,
well, you know what? I got a bunch of those.
Yeah.
You got a bunch of those.
Mikey, have you come back down or no?
Yeah, I'll do one.
Those
more.
Are crappy dice.
I think not yet.
The red ones are good.
Were you searching a room or anything? You being inappropriate?
No, actually.
10.
Appropriate.
You're good. You're say it again?
No, I'm not being inappropriate. It's all good. It's
okay.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so Wanlo and Edison have had too much, and they are -1 for all rolls for the remainder of the evening.
Woohoo! Now let's go pick that lock.
Except for their self-perceived intelligence, which is +8.
And strength.
And stealthiness. You go pick up that piano.
Stealthiness is an 11.
Although -5 for whiskey.
All right, so we can break here, or do you want to keep going? 11:30.
11:30.
Yeah,
we'll keep going. Let's get
into
the basement.
I'm on vacation.
Okay.
What?
All right.
So is it cleared out enough that I can start trying to pick the lock in the lift?
It's hard to tell. People are still wandering around.
Oh, okay.
Guys, go get some snacks out of the kitchen.
Let's go get some snacks out of the kitchen.
Snacks.
Alright,
you want to bring the kitchen up there, Adam? It's just all the way to the right.
Yeah.
Over the kitchen again?
Oh, believe me, I remember where the kitchen is.
Alright, so.
It's all rooms.
It's the size of the pantry there. Oh my god.
Put a
You gotta feed 100 girls.
112.
Are you in the pantry? Are you in the kitchen? What are you looking
we're
at?
We're looking for snacks.
All right, so you don't see anything. You don't see anything that hasn't already been devoured in the kitchen. Empty bags.
Or look at the pantry.
Let's check the pantry. I don't even know what this
I
is.
I said, guys, where's the pantry?
What's Emperor? Is that?
Where?
Emperor, right here next to the pantry.
It looks like a toilet. Mike, you came back down and rejoined the guys?
I'm down now.
Okay. Mike, he comes out with a shitty grin on his face.
More like 2 minutes
two.
Later.
No, he was loaded up.
Yeah, 3 minutes of conversation.
All right, so, Jeff, give me a notice check in the pantry. Adam, you are in the pantry with him?
We see Bonnie in
here?
Sure. Low, minus one, notice check.
Notice check.
Should I notice?
Do I have a good notice?
Did you go in the pantry with him? Or did you just keep the girls company so they wouldn't wander away?
I imagine I'm with the girls.
I noticed that we are in a pantry.
Nine.
You find it.
Wow.
You're able to...
By the dumbwaiter?
Would
you like something?
You move several boxes and you find a trapdoor.
You find a book that magically moves and clicks. A wisp of air comes between. On the floor?
Yes. Going down.
Going down?
Going down.
Towards the basement.
Into the basement.
Classic. You put the box back.
Is there any other sound?
I put the box in the back and go say it.
Okay. You bring some snacks out. You find some smart food and a bag of Doritos.
These girls don't have any smart food.
What kind of Doritos? Cool Ranch?
No. Original, man.
Yeah.
Girls
intense are pickle? I'll give them an intense pickle.
I'll just give them credit.
Is that what it was?
All right, so the girls are there. They're giggling and laughing, and you can push.
I go around to everybody except Edison and tell them what I found in the paper.
Okay.
Girl,
excellent choice.
I would like to make a toast. Did you know the Roman said that toast, because what they used to do was take bread and heat it up, and then they would dip it in the wine, and that's why we call it toast today. So here's to
But he's still talking. One of them does a shot and just passes out right at the table.
Thank God.
I'll drink to that.
It's like shooting fish in a barrel.
Oh, look at Jay passed out. We'll be right back. We're going to take her up to her room.
Okay.
What room is that? 520?
We'll be okay.
Okay. Take your time.
Okay.
Make sure you go to the bathroom. Go to the bathroom and drink some water.
Put her face down so she doesn't vomit and kill herself.
Edison nods at this advice and he gets up to go upstairs to go get some water.
No, Edison.
What?
Edison, we got some Motrin and water right here for you.
Oh.
Bye,
all right, so they wander aimlessly around. It's pretty quiet at this point.
Excellent.
Guys, it's pretty quiet at this point.
Hey, why don't we go check out what's in the pantry? I'm hungry, Edison. Come on in.
Oh.
Maybe they got some pork rinds.
Ooh, yeah.
Nachos.
There's
nachos in there?
Chicharrone.
Chicharrone.
Yeah, come on
with me.
Look around. Nobody's following us. Nobody sees us.
Nope, nobody notices you. Yeah.
Are there any security cameras in the area?
I'm with you, too. I'm gotcha. All right, red dice.
Don't forget your minus one.
Minus one. Ah, oh my goodness, I got box cards and veils.
Four plus two is 6, 5.
You got a 2. Niner.
Niner.
That's appropriate.
There's a camera in the kitchen pointing the other way, so it sees, it's not for active monitoring, it's probably more at this point for video recording. Especially since there's nobody awake actively.
So I run by it.
So it may not even be out for all you can tell.
There's no red light.
Let's make sure.
All right.
Like every movie.
Yeah.
So you get into
the
pantry. Yep.
I couldn't close the door.
Okay. It's a little snug.
Put
you can do that.
Put it in front of it. The same
thing. Can I show everybody where the door is?
What?
All right.
You know where this door goes?
It goes down.
All right.
We're going down?
You opening it?
Wait a minute. Before we go, let's check around the kitchen for a flashlight.
We're in the pantry. It's got to be.
Oh, we got
pantry.
Our phones.
Yeah, cell phones.
Flashlights.
Yeah,
okay.
Let's turn the light off.
But how old are we?
What
Jesus.
Happens if the light bulb pops and EMP happens? Our flashlights? Oh, never mind. It wouldn't work anyway. Let's go. Candles.
We turn the light off.
It's dark.
It's battery based.
Guys.
Dark. Cracker.
Guys, it's really dark. It's really dark.
Edison, I need a vigor check.
Wait a minute. My hands. I woke up. My hands
two.
In between two
minus
pillows.
Two.
Those aren't two pillows. Those are two
pillows. Six.
Holy crap.
Edison tastes vomit, but he doesn't throw up yet.
Oh, God.
Mm.
Did
I say, everybody be quiet. We turn the lights off, and I slowly open up the trap door.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Basement.
There's a stairway that leads down. You actually get a slight whiff of, like you would in a burned house.
Oh.
Just keep them covered.
Char.
Char.
Well, one low will go first.
Is somebody shining a light down for him?
No.
Ouch.
Slowly walk down.
No,
it's a ladder.
Run.
Thank you. It's a ladder.
Yeah.
Nice. I'm going to go ahead and grab the edges with the feet on the outside.
Wood.
Wando, use your low light vision. Use your low light
I heard that
vision.
Last time. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. I appreciate that.
All right. Does anybody have any weapons on them?
We brought all of our weapons.
One,
I thought.
Two.
I grabbed a knife from the pantry.
I have my regular knife, but not the gun, so.
We have the pointy thing.
Switchblade in your shoe?
What are you, Puerto Rican? I
have
my knife.
No, Leroy Brown.
Leroy
Brown?
I always have a knife on me. It says it in my character sheet.
Yeah. The little 2-inch Swiss Army?
Oh, yeah. It's big time. It's big time.
Hey, it's a D4.
It can.
It's equivalent to punching somebody in the face.
Dangerous.
Yeah. All right, so.
You're at East University. Everybody's got a Bowie knife.
So if you guys had gone into the regular basement somehow,
the
regular basement is
chains, whips,
I'm petrograms,
panties,
chips, dips, high school party.
It's like my basement.
Just pass the whole about this.
Oh boy.
So if you zoom out. It's really neat because there's a whole half the section where you can't see what there is.
Is this from the thing, or you looked this up?
This is the third part of the basement plan. So if you came down on the left, which you guys didn't make it down on that left.
Oh, it's like theater.
Yeah, but the whole right hand side is completely untouched. It's perfect.
Mm. Wow. Future stage? It doesn't exist yet.
No.
Wait, concerts are there?
It's either that or it's a time machine because this is the future stage.
Well, no, but they may be planning
maybe
to build,
the
build that in the future. But anyway, you're on the right hand side of
that's
map.
For you. You do your hazing rituals, and everybody who else is part of the sorority watches. And
yeah, that's all the it's all the sorority stuff. So, and actually, I am going to stop there tonight.
Okay.
We're moving to the next stop.
Oh, yeah, the lift actually does go down there.
Yeah, the lift does go down there.
Not going anywhere.
Josh has
nothing else to do.
Once we clean up, it'll be 12 o'clock anyway. So, all set, Mikey?
I'm good, man. That was awesome.
That was fun. Thanks, guys.
Wait, can we kill something? Hold on a second.
Okay, I'm going to stop the recording now.